3-4 weeks. What the fuck?
It's been kind of slow.
The only game that came out was like Defiance at the beginning of the month. That's been.
Oh my god! Defiance! We can
talk about Defiance!
I'll talk about that for a whole, like, maybe 50 seconds.
Alright. Well, do it in the pre-show then.
What? About what?
Free Defiance! Wow!
Whoa! Yeah.
What a piece of shit!
What, you wanted to play that game? You wanted Alex to play it.
I wanted a game that I could play on my Xbox while I'm rendering and editing and stuff, and that did not fit the bill.
Yeah, because the servers are down like every 8 minutes.
So, were you actually looking for a casual game you wanted to play?
Yeah, pretty much. What, like, just something I can play while I'm doing that.
What about Smite? Why is that a casual game?
Fuck that. No, that requires internet.
Oh, yeah.
And it's not on the Xbox, yeah. So what the fuck are you talking about?
I did not hear the Xbox part.
Yeah, I can't play while I'm like rendering and
what
stuff.
What about Call of Duty? What about it?
No, I haven't even touched Black Ops 2 multiplayer. I still haven't played.
What about that new zombie map coming up?
Next week. I'll play that.
Oh, hey, that.
Oh. Write that on the list, you piece of shit.
Okay.
There we go.
Wow.
Boss DLC.
Boss DLC.
Interesting.
Boss DLC.
Yeah, it's been kind of like a slow 3 weeks, has it?
Well, March was pretty packed, and then April was kind of.
Bleh. Not looking for just like releases though. I'm talking news in general.
I'm telling you. Well, there's
how many news sites do you go on?
I actually have one only now.
One only. What is it?
Joystick.
I use that as well.
Oh, well, now you feel stupid.
I know they post shit. Yeah, they do post shit.
All right. Well, there is something else that did come out. It was the DLC for Metal Gear Rising, which I haven't played yet.
I thought you said you did play.
Not yet.
Can't really talk about that. I haven't played it either. I didn't even buy it yet.
I did buy it. I downloaded it and everything. It's really sick.
So anyway, Sly bought DLC.
Wow.
Is this our pre-show?
Yeah, apparently.
The rest of this shit wasn't the pre-show, but now this is.
There's a pre-show in there somewhere.
I'll find a pre-show in there.
He'll find a pre-show.
Were you recording when I talked about Awesome Game Defiance?
Yeah, I did.
Oh, okay.
That game is the bee's knees out there.
It sounds like servers down the game is pretty much server simulator. It's down, always
Wait,
down.
Wait, also, did you guys see that the EA got again for the second year the worst company ever, and they actually...
It's like worst consumerist.
It's customer
like
support
that.
Whatever, something like that. But
they do that pretty bad.
They refined it as to like worst company, and then they made... a letter in retaliation. You're like, comparing to like other worst companies have actually done worse, but majority of people are just upset over the fact that
EA sucks.
SimCity. It was their main concern of like, wow, EA sucks with SimCity, and then like the CEO like wrote this like completely like Seamus style letter, just shitting on everybody because this company that has done way worse, you know, but us. It's just I can't go into full details because I don't remember it because I have the attention.
The CEO quit too. Or was fired.
I think he got
let
go.
Something happened. It wasn't too long ago either.
So buy their shirts from EA.
That guy has so much money. He doesn't even care.
He probably got like a $5 million severance package. I'm sure he did.
It's not even just SimCity, though.
No, I know. They screw up everything.
Yeah, they have like every new release. There's something fucked up with it. So it's like, we've got to cover our asses. It was just SimCity. That was what
was
going
down.
The
first time they, like, I don't know. People were like praising him. Like, wow, way to go. You... made that.
Okay, well, this is the end of the pre-show. Okay, welcome everyone to Creature Talk. Creature Talk for...
It's like the 14th or something? Or the 13th?
4-13.
How is it?
4-13,
2013.
Got a fucking calendar right above. Right above. And I've been marking them off day
I'm
by
used
day.
To.
That
you
is
have marked off the 13th as if it is done. Because
I ain't going to fucking come back down here to mark it off later. I mark it off in the morning.
You have one job in the beginning. It's to tell the fucking date. And you.
He marked it off. It's not. It's.
I came back from my trip and none of those were marked off. So I had to update it up until
and
whatever.
By the way, Coots, what day is it today? Saturday. Fucking do the line thing.
But
like,
it's marked off.
Are you fucking
it's
serious?
Marked off. You're
saying because I already marked off Saturday.
It's done. So it's the 14th.
Hey, come Sunday.
Hey, everybody, the Messiah, the new God, James. When he says the day is off, Kucha believes it, and it's
it. Done.
You're the Messiah, man.
Saturday's gone.
Those red X's are convincing. Look at that.
Convincing.
Permanent, also.
How do you feel about your new job title, Mr. James, the God?
Map keeper?
Date keeper. You're Father Time now.
Father Time.
Yeah. You like that?
All right. So I guess I'll etch off your guys' Tuesday and Thursdays.
Okay.
Those are gone.
So I don't have to come? Because
they don't even gone. Exist. Oh, okay. You just skip the day.
So it's Monday. Thursday
is gone. Sunday and Thursday. Monday is also gone, so your days off are gone.
We're just losing days of the year now.
We have Wednesday, Friday, Saturday was already
gone. What day is stuff going to release then?
No, Sunday's gone.
If Tuesday's gone, whatever and day Sunday's left, gone,
he seems to have deleted every single day.
No, you get the extra Nintendo releases on Sunday.
But Sunday's gone.
Sorry.
Everything's gone. Oh, yeah, Sunday is gone. Wednesday. What comes out on Wednesdays?
Like some DLC sometimes.
Wednesdays. Yeah, the Xbox Live DLC. Hey, there you go.
Thank you for giving James his power. He is using it very well.
Anyway, we're sitting here with James. We're sitting here with Sly. We're sitting here with Seamus and myself.
And fuck James, apparently, you know.
Huh?
Did you hear him mention you?
What? I mentioned
you did
it.
Mention me. Oh. Mentioned me
you
first.
Couldn't hear me mention. I said like two or three things and you lost it.
Oh my
it.
God.
He's just so surprised that all the days are gone. Except for like two of them. He's in we only have like Wednesday and Friday left.
What happened to those days? I'm still thinking about them.
Gone. They got X'd out.
Tomorrow's Friday. Oh, done. Tomorrow's Wednesday. Oh, tomorrow's Friday.
We don't even know what we're talking week. About because they can't see the fucking calendar.
2-day work week.
We should set this up as a video podcast then. That's what I thought.
Feeding into the people here.
Oh, man.
Anyway, so this is our creature talk for, you know, that date I told you that have turned into this massive debate of time. And James being Father Time, and he doesn't even have a big beard or a cloak or anything.
He has a beard. Beard.
It's not a big beard. It's Father big, Time's yeah. beard is huge.
It's more well, of a beard than you have.
Maybe he's Kid Time. Youngster time.
Kid time.
What?
Sounds like a new game.
Okay, so let's get to Kid Time. Let's get to the topics, the nitty gritty.
Nitty gritty.
Yes.
James, you're first on the list if you want.
Why am I? I've got all this other shit that's gonna be like.
You're Kid Time, man.
Something that's kind of fresh in our minds. Me and Seamus watched the Far Cry 3 Blood Dragon DLC trailer, which is pretty much like Ubisoft going in and making. An 80s like it's like Tron mixed with
it's like the G.I. Joe cartoons
like,
or
old cartoon style
He-Man
so it's pretty crazy what? And
it looks pretty
it's
good.
Really yeah. wonky it's pretty much
a lot of people
are
making a big
around.
Deal out of it like it's like you know, oh my god they're thinking out of the box but it's like but, Saints did the same exact shit like yeah, I don't
it kind of reminded sense. Me of
it looks good but like it's not like fucking whoa never
wait,
been done
wait,
before
does it revolve around anything on the story
no it has nothing to do with it it's pretty much them having fun with their engine doing a bunch of different crazy things because it looks really cool because they've like retextured and remodeled a ton of stuff and crazy different kinds of guns and it looks
it's like how the late 80s looked with all like the neon
yeah it's
pink
like
and
Blade
and,
Runner
yeah kinda,
oh, that's kind of cool I guess
it's like that
it's pretty wonky but it looks fun and it's coming out May 1st
yep
so a few weeks here
what the fuck you want get out of here
this cat is just being our dude
kitty
he's part of our posse
here kitty
come on
just roaming around while we're doing the fucking podcast
where'd the pink one
he wasn't meowing
at
least.
He
doesn't
work
on Far Cry.
I did get
distracted. But yeah, I'm excited for it.
Look good.
I am marking that there off there.
With red, because it's permanent now, so we will never ever talk about it
it's
again.
It's gone for good. There is no DLC.
Kiss it goodbye.
Anyway, do you want to... Does Sly want to go crazy over that?
Which one? Let me see.
BioShock Infinite, which came out like 10 years ago.
Years ago. All right, well.
It was last generation.
When I was 14, I was playing BioShock Infinite.
You're 24?
He is 24.
Are you fucking serious?
You're old.
Says the guy
you're
that
won.
Wait, let's.
Wait, right. Yeah, you go to bed at like 8 p.m.
Says the guy
you're
that
old,
goes to bed early. All right, check me out, guys. I need to, before we talk about BioShock Infinite and my 14. When I was 14. But anyways, Kucha's old as shit. I went, all right, by the way, I went to the tax agent that Kucha hooked me up, and I was talking to him, and he's like, I was like, how old is Kucha? I'm like, he's one of the youngest ones.
He's like 21 or 22?
Yeah, well, Horton, but I'm trying.
He called him Horton?
For the fan base.
You know my nickname.
For the fan base. He's like, we're talking about you, and I'm like, at the end of the day, it came down to, like...
I don't even think I said Horton to him before.
Like, I said Horton, I don't give a fuck.
You did?
Yeah.
He's like, man, he's probably thinking, you're so Latino.
How is that a bad thing? He has Latino in him.
But damn.
No, I know, but...
You're super Latino.
You're like...
but...
A new form of Latino.
Horton's telling me that I'm old, yet he's the one married already. Is that... I think that's already a win right there.
I think the marriage age has kind of gone down lately, though.
What?
People getting married.
Anybody, more and more early now. This motherfucker probably will have a baby before any of us.
That'd be funny.
You know what?
Can you imagine? I'm going to get them all red hats. They're all going to have red hats.
Meow. Good, you can't. All the time. That'll be annoying. But anyways, Bioshock Infinite, because this asshole decided. I played just because Alex finished it not too long ago, and he's like,
this is really good.
What? No,
this is really good.
No, yeah.
You should play this.
No, he was doing it for some things, for some projects that he had to do, and he goes, he's like,
he already announced the project, though, I think.
What?
You could...
No, the Sanity?
Yeah.
No.
I thought you were just... the project, like, it's a secret.
Well, he had other things for his channel, too. So, there you go.
Oh, okay. There you go. You spoiled it.
Whoa!
Now you...
No.
Spoiled it, asshole.
No.
But he was like... He came over. I was playing. I think I was playing Smite. He comes over to my room. He just go,
yo.
I'm like, what, Alex? It's like,
are you finishing Bioshock yet?
I'm like, no, I'm only like an hour into it. He's like,
finish it so we can talk about the ending.
And that's it. He's like, finish it. So we can
just
talk about
out.
The ending. He just
walked out. Had he been smoking anything before? Because that picture of him was very strange.
No, it just
yo, like, man.
That's what we do, though.
Yo.
That's what we talk when we're like fucking around with
yo.
Each other. Go, yo, dude. I'm like, he's like, what? It's like, we always kind of like punk each other with
yo.
That. And,
sly.
And he just told me, you have to play. I'm like, I already have fun with it in the beginning. I was playing normal and I just wanted to finish it normal. But he's like, fuck normal. Just play it on easy so you can watch the story. I'm like, okay, whatever. And even on easy, I actually managed to die a few times, which is kind of like, I guess a testament. It doesn't...
Wow.
I don't know, it's kind of...
Difficulty must be there, then.
Well,
it's like Dark Souls.
In normal, it's pretty shitty, actually. It's pretty bad.
I don't think I've died on normal yet, though.
I play Reckless, so...
I play Reckless, too. I just go in. I don't even spawn cover. I was talking about it. I'm like, people are going to yell at me because I'm not spawning in cover. I'm like, I just want to go in and shoot, get shot, like... It makes it more interesting to me.
The game itself, like, the only thing, I don't want to spoil it to anybody, just the same thing that Alex told me. Play it for the ending, because you'll be so mindfucked. It's one of those games that really just, like, doesn't, like, make you feel like you're a dumbass. Like, yeah, the one thing that does, and I like, was, like, anytime, if you're playing on the computer, when you press N, it will guide you to the destination. But the story itself, it gives, it's worthwhile. It makes you feel like... I don't know, being
it was all a dream.
No.
M. Night Shyamalan the game?
No.
M. Night Shyamalan
tried right there.
This.
Do you know what I'm talking about? You know the reference I'm making.
I know. What? But I said I know.
What is it then?
I don't want to say it cuz I don't know it.
What? That's exactly what I was asking. You're like, "No, I know." Don't.
You're talking about a specific movie?
I'm just saying that's what he's known for. Is a few of his older movies, he would have the massive twist at the end. That you're like, oh, whoa.
It's
the one movie, it wasn't Signs, it was...
The Village?
Yes! Is that the one?
Yeah.
Man, that was shit.
No, but like...
Adrian Brody one, right?
Adrian Brody.
The one where they were dressed up as monsters, like, at the end?
Yeah.
Right? Yeah, God, that was fucking retarded! Oh, God! Oh!
But anyways,
Adrian Brody.
So just so I can wrap this up... Play the whole gameplay is amazing. I didn't get to play the first or the second Bioshock that much, but you don't need to. This is like a Bioshock on its own.
No,
so you don't need to, like, if you're like worried that, oh, I never played the first or the second one, doesn't matter, buy it, it's worth it.
They just have like some symbolism.
First and second ones are really good.
Yeah, they're really, really fucking good.
I haven't gotten to them yet.
Second one is ass.
The second one wasn't
really?
That good.
Second one is?
It was just like on rails, literally, for the most part.
Like I said, I wish I could speak more of everything, but I'm just scared of like spoiling because I'm a master at spoiling shit. So.
Well, you just spoiled The Village. So.
Would you?
Yeah, I mean,
shit
I
about
know.
The Village.
I know that they were all dressed up, like, since the beginning. All these monsters, they're just people in fucking dress up clothes.
So I guess.
What are you going to say?
What do you think of the racism? A lot of people upset about it.
You know what? It just...
They're upset that the game is set in a time period where there was
racism,
and it's accurate, so they're
Django
mad.
Django all over again.
Django.
Yeah, it's Django
the
game.
I personally think that it's the racism didn't bother me because I'm not in that mentality. I'm
yeah.
like, whatever. Like,
it would bother me. I would.
You would be upset. Oh, man,
you like, get,
God,
you get to
the
first racist part and be like, I'm done.
What's the guy, the dude's name that, I forget his name. Is it something Levine, I think?
Avril Lavigne?
No. I said the dude's name!
Dude,
and you fucking come up with Avril Lavigne.
Skater boy over here.
Oh my God.
No way, you're acting like
no, the fucking guy that, like, the dude that, like, made the story or whatever. He's on Twitter.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know.
Like, Adam Levine or something like that. I don't know.
I know what you're talking about.
Isn't that a singer?
Yeah, that might be a singer.
Yeah, he was in the ERB. I think he was in ERB.
I don't know what the fuck I'm talking about right now.
The guy that made the story.
Yeah.
Pretty much.
I'll tweet to him. I'll be like, you fucking asshole. Racist.
I liked it. The racism didn't bother me. It was really subtle. It wasn't like they just have like black people being workers. Like
And then it was like the mixed relationship. They didn't want that. They had them kind of on stage.
Actually, they talk about two races. They talk about Asians and they talk about black people. And I think what was it?
Surprised they weren't talking about the Irish there too. Because
harsh.
Yeah, they were very upset. They didn't like the Irish for a while. That might have been the 1800s though. Yeah. That might have been.
I think it's just the game just really. The one thing that I did feel is, like, I was just so sucked in into the game. Like, I was just, like, lost, like, all grasp of everything going around me. I was just, like, thrown into the game, and I was just, like, the story was really, like, captivating. It was cool.
Yeah, the game goes to hell pretty quick.
That's pretty fucking deep.
It's deep.
Why do you say it like
you
that?
Know what?
On a scale of 1 to 5 Street Fighters, how good is the story?
The story goes beyond Street Fighter.
Does it? Wow.
What? Actually, no. Though, by the way, though, just so you're aware, I never like any of the stories in Street Fighter. I'm more of Mortal Kombat. But thank you for being a piece of shit friend that you are.
Did you like the Mortal Kombat story where they killed Liu Kang?
Which one was it? That, like, the
when they introduced Quan Chi.
I didn't Quan like Chi. It. I thought it was wonky as shit.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You liked it, didn't you?
Yeah, you liked it? Wow. I was so tired of Liu Kang being that guy. I was like, fuck you.
Wow.
But yeah, no. Just for the ending itself, when you guys are going to be playing it, you're going to be enjoying the whole thing, the fighting mechanism, everything is fucking legit. The only thing I didn't like, this is the part I don't want to talk about it, because I don't know if Seamus is in it yet.
I can tell you where I'm at.
Where you at?
I'm trying to remember where I left off. I know I got the airship from, I got it back.
Have you fought a really big dude that their weak spot is in the heart?
I fought like 2 or 3 of them.
You
by
mean
now.
The guy from the trailer?
The handyman?
I think is that.
They yeah, they call him the handyman.
By the way, there's everybody has said it and it got me. There's one jump scare in the game.
There's one. Is it a ladder jump scare?
No, there's only one jump scare. Just one.
Don't
jump
talk about
scare.
It.
I'm not. It's so epic. I was playing it. Beck was doing some stuff in the house and Alex was with his door open. And I went.
I heard you. I heard you because me and him were talking, and I heard you.
You heard me?
Like, yeah, Alex was like, he got to the end or whatever. He got to the jump scare, something like that.
And it's actually, and that the one thing that made you jump, you can avoid most of the time, like when you see him in the game. But it's just so perfect. The game is so good. It's
pretty good.
I'm content. Like one thing I want to say is, like, I wish they gave you more money. Cause like you don't.
They give you a shit ton.
No,
like
you don't unlock a lot of the things. Like you don't unlock a lot of things. A lot of the weapons I didn't get all the unlocks.
No, you really got to play the first two then. Cause
new game plus is for that.
How much have you played of the first two games? Cause like you really start to hurt for supplies towards the end because they don't give you a lot of money. They don't give you a lot of supplies.
They
like,
don't give you shit.
You really have to take up a lot of perks and stuff where you find more stuff. And
that's
and
what
like, I've had a lot of easier time though.
I maxed my possession. That's because I wanted to like constantly like steal money from the vending machines.
I've had an easier time like in the first two games, they give you a set amount of guns. Like, you have to have them. In this game, you only get two, and you can switch them out for whatever. Like, it seems like they streamlined it a lot more for the third one.
You'll see, even if you, let's say the machine gun, like, you're just like, oh, here's a shotgun, and I have a sniper, and I don't want to worry
but
about
it's like,
there's going to be scenarios where, like, let's say a sniper rifle is, like needed. They'll make sure that a sniper rifle is
close
to you.
They do.
Where, I don't know, it's just like, I thought that I was gonna have to keep two specific guns and I'd level everything up.
No, you can switch.
It's just annoying. I feel like you don't get enough money.
Like, first two are a lot. You probably won't like the first two then, cause they really kind of.
I just thought that they gave you so many abilities and it gave you so many like weapons. I thought that you can actually like max them out as you went on. It's just like this is my first experience to fully like capitalize on a BioShock, and it's just like.
I think they made it better.
It is. And by the way, I will say this: Elizabeth is the best AI partner in any video game I ever seen.
Wow.
The best AI partner. The best.
No.
She makes it a lot easier. She
what about
like
the dog
stuff
from Fable 3?
What, C-Nanners?
Yeah, name mine C-Nanners.
No.
My poodle.
The best. Anybody that has played the whole game will say that she is. Like, parts when she was not around you, you'd be like, damn it, I miss her. I need help.
Yeah, because she gives you stuff.
She gives you so much shit.
She's like, oh, you're low on shotgun ammo? Here's the full thing.
No, the one thing that I like is when she gives you money, there's like this specific noise when it lands in your ting. Hand. It just sounds like a... Or it just sounds so perfect. I can't emulate it. I just every time I would get
money. You
know
money, when money lands in your hand.
Then you find out how they made that sound, and it was just one of the devs like slapping their ball sack against their
then
leg.
I will go to that dev and slap his ball sack. Because it sounds like...
So you can hear it again?
Yeah, it's like here, coin. Tweet. And it's like a specific... It feels so good.
I think you can only get like that really thick, like
with a coin,
boom, like
so
slapping the side of the thigh, pretty much, I think.
Oh, yeah, it sounds...
See? I mean...
But yeah, no, Elizabeth, best AI, best story that I've seen so far in the game, at least that I played recently, and yeah, I'm excited for anybody else out there that's going to try it. Tell me if you like it.
I'll get to it eventually. James had a hunch when that was going on sale. There's like some pre-order bonuses and stuff, and I got like five games for free for getting it. Because there's one site that gives out the Steam codes when you buy it.
Yeah.
And then it gave
They
me
had
two
their
free
own
games.
Promotional thing, and then Steam had their tier thing, like where you know as much pre-orders as you get, like unlocked
everyone a bunch of stuff.
It was already up to tier 3, so you got like what was it?
I think it was
XCOM or something.
Yeah, XCOM and then something else.
Yeah.
BioShock 1.
Yeah.
Like
and then
so
the other site was BioShock
Infinite,
1.
The two games, and then BioShock 1 and then XCOM.
Cool.
For pre-ordering it.
It's a lot of free
games. And it was like, wasn't it discounted too a little bit, or was it still like $50?
I think you still probably pay the full price.
I think so, but yeah, I got all those extra games,
and it
worked.
Just to wrap it up with this one, BioShock, worth it. Anybody
that's
that
worth
has
it. I haven't even
out,
touched it yet.
Probably
one of the best games of the year so far.
Yeah. Like, the story, the everything, the gameplay, everything just like, it's just dead on.
It's damn well better legend. For as many times as it was delayed.
Yeah.
Well,
it was delayed
worth
a lot.
It. It
that's
was,
right.
And I just like the fact that even like just a little. This is not. They hint stuff from like the first and the second BioShock, but it's like, you don't. It's not. Doesn't really ruin this. Like it's a game of it on its own. Like, I feel like if it wanted to go, continuously to other.
That
like,
has been
games,
the first game in a while that hasn't. Well, I guess it's technically still after BioShock 2, right?
Or no, it's in the early 1900s. It's
okay.
Before everything happened.
Okay, so in that case, it's doing 1-2 sequel instead of 1-2-3 sequel.
I think
it's
weird.
Prequel.
It's
sorry.
Weird. It's weird because when you finish it, you're gonna be confused. You won't know actually which BioShock was. It's like it fucks you up. Like I looked into previous BioShocks, and I'm like, all right, this is this, and I talked to Alex, and he's like. No, you're wrong.
It's an alternate story.
Majority of the people that finished the game, and this is true, and I did it too, Alex was like, guess what's going to happen? When you finish the game, you're either going to come to me, or you're going to go to a website. And,
Wiki.
No, actually, I went Wiki. To, I just put BioShock ending explanation, because I went to
explanation?
Like, some things I couldn't mix, like some things were like so weird, like it fucks you up, like you can completely throw yourself into it.
Yeah, the game starts to get weird.
But if
after
it's
a
meant,
point.
If it's meant to jumble you up like that, how do you know that someone has a definitive answer to the explanation?
It just made sense. Like if it just made sense. Believe me, majority of people.
What if someone else could give you something that like was the opposite of that and it still made sense? Then what?
I don't know.
I have the beholder.
Yeah.
You don't know.
I don't care, but I feel at peace right now.
Yeah.
Because I know a majority
for
of
now.
Feel at peace?
For now.
Yes. You should watch Lost.
Laid it to rest.
No!
Going crazy. Watch that stupid show.
I get BioShock 5 will be Goldberg's out of 5.
I asked you about Street Fighters out of
Street Fighters. That's, you've been to the story. I mean, the overall game.
Okay,
asshole.
Mortal Kombat's.
How many Mortal Kombat's I give it? I give it 5 Mortal Kombat's out of 5.
Man, okay, well, the highest degree of Mortal Kombat rank.
Yeah.
Unbelievable.
So what's next?
Do you want to pick, like,
I don't know,
a segment of your stories to tell?
I guess. I don't know.
You don't have to go into full details.
So, I just recently got back from my trip from WrestleMania. I did the Access thing, which is pretty much, like, it is pretty much what I said it was going to be. It's a convention for just wrestling stuff. Really shitty.
Really?
Like, right. It was, like, it's nothing. I feel like they should have, like, from someone that's been at, like, convention centers, actual convention centers, didn't feel right having that in an arena. Because it was, like, they have shit set up as if it was a convention around the circle. Like, mm-hmm. around the circle, and then you go down into the actual arena, and then they have a ring set up. They have, it was literally a bunch of, like, Fruity Pebbles shit for John Cena or whatever. But, like... They had a Fruity Pebble volcano. They had a Fruity Pebble fucking like ring that
quick question. Fruity Pebble, you mean like the actual cereal?
Yeah. They had just fucking cereal stations where you can actually eat cereal. I was like, what the fuck is the point of that? Why? I was like, people are gonna eat cereal.
Quick question. Yeah. Are wrestling fans really big fans of
cereal? Man, cereal and milk, they got that.
They throw money at sponsorships, there's got to be some kind of market there. So
Yeah, they do the research.
So am I expecting a cover of John Cena putting Fred Flintstone?
John Cena's on the cover already. He's on the cover.
Putting a Fred Flintstone in a, like a...
No, it's like a cartoon version of him on the cover.
Oh my God.
Yeah. Hey, you can look it up. It's like cheesy looking, but like he's on the cover already. But, like, so they have a volcano, and I didn't know what the hell it was when I was taking pictures of it. I was like, what the fuck is that thing? It looks like a giant, like a rainbow pile of shit or something. I didn't know what the fuck it was. But then, like, I heard them mention, like, they mentioned in the ring, they were like, you know, you can check out our, you know, Fruity Pebble volcano. I was like, oh, that's what the fuck it is. I didn't know that. But they have a ball pit. That was filled with Fruity Pebbles. Like,
what?
But it wasn't, real. Like, they were just, like sizable, like, just... color of Fruity Pebbles and stuff like that. I was like, man, I want to jump in that. And then I seen the very next day when we went in for no, it wasn't for WrestleMania. It was for the Raw after. It was on Monday. We went to the arena that they had the access at. They have dumpsters in the back, and in the dumpsters in the back, they had all the Fruity Pebbles. I was like, why you fucking throw them out? I was like, I would have fucking took them. Like, they're just a bunch
of... You should have gotten a bunch of plastic bags and gone back.
Just start like...
Yeah. I don't know how the fuck I'd bring that back, but my cousin was saying, like, maybe because they're dirty and stuff, all the people jumping in them, I guess. I don't know, maybe they'd have to swap it out. But, like, I was like, I would have fucking loved to have a ball pit with fucking Fruity Pebbles in it. I mean, you don't even see that they're Fruity Pebbles. Like, if I were to bring them, like, they were just... colorful ball pits, like it was just foam balls.
Yeah.
So I was like, man, I
could you eat them. Like,
they were really...
Go ahead and try slide.
No, I'm saying, were they actual fruit?
You could eat it.
No, they're shapes. Foam. They're like foam shapes of them.
You could eat it, but it wouldn't end well.
I would probably be
get some be dead.
Yeah. Then they had a giant spoon too, like a plastic spoon. I guess they just scoop it out. So I don't know. It's fucking retarded.
That's clever.
But
that's
then really they had clever. They had the video game station there, which I was just like, was flicking them off while they were over there.
Man, but that, you know,
they did update. They took the time to update the THQ logo though. It says 2K now. Yep. It says 2K now.
But you know, the wrestling game.
I'm pretty sure they re-released it.
There now.
Yeah, they re-released it for $60 for 2K. Again. They re-released it under 2K. $60 again.
The same game.
The same game.
Yep. They probably just swapped out the intro on the disc.
I don't know.
And they swapped out on the thing.
2K. That's pretty much it.
Yeah, I wonder.
2K.
I wonder if they switched the intro and stuff.
I'm sure they did. I doubt they did anything else.
I wanted to know like who was taking control of the servers then. Like, I wonder if 2K's taking control of the servers.
You know that saying, if it ain't broken... Why fix it? But in this one, it's broken. Mm. Fuck it.
They had that booth. They had all the. It was literally the whole left side was all Fruity Pebbles shit. The right side was the game and action figures. And then like further up was the ring. And then they had the private signings for like the bigger wrestlers all the way back, like all the way like towards the fucking entrance for Raw. And you could only go in, like, a specific line. They had a security guy there, like, you know, tying it off and shit like that. So they had a few matches at Access with just, like, some of the lower-end, like,
good.
You know, development guys. So it was all right. But, I'm like, in terms of, like the convention-type shit that they had up there, it was just, like, stuff that I didn't care about. Like, it's not worth the fucking price
What? Just because you're old enough right now, if you were younger, you think you would have given a fuck about
it? I don't know.
If you were a child, okay, which
there was some stuff that was pretty cool. Like, they had, like, pieces of, like, you know, Triple H's entrance from the one WrestleMania where he had, like, a throne and stuff, and they actually had the throne there. But then they had other shit where it's just, like, it's Mick Foley's shirt. It's like,
Whoa!
Mick Foley's shirt! It's like... Stone Cold shirt, something like that. It's just like, I don't care about that stuff. But they had, like, other stuff, like props that were pretty cool. Like the, you know, limos that they bust up they had outside.
Really?
Which is pretty cool. But just, like, the clothes and stuff that they had inside, it was, like, really lackluster. Then they had, like, cardboard cutouts of wrestlers all around the circle. And some of them were placed in such retarded spots. Like, Kane was in front of the bathroom. And I was like, it's like he was blocking the bathroom. I was like, kids are stopping to take a picture with this Kane cutout. right in front of the bathroom. And then they have, the, you know, like when we go to like, you know, PAX or whatever, they have those screens where you can tweet the pictures and it'll live up there.
Yeah.
I see pictures of like kids standing in front of the bathroom next to Kane. And it just says men's like above. And I'm just like, that's a shitty picture. Like, what the fuck? But it didn't, I mean, some of the stuff was cool, but like I honestly probably wouldn't buy that again, like if I were to go again, because it doesn't seem like it's
not
much.
Worth it.
It's not much there. So then
who was signing?
They had everybody signing, but they had swapped out, like they had on for the Ticketmaster thing, you have to buy a specific ticket for two people, like for two signings or whatever. So it would be like, you know, Punk and Ric Flair would be in one session. You'd get both of them, but like you couldn't get any of the other ones.
That
was like
shit.
It was like it was a specific timing thing. Like you could get all the lower end people. Like they had like lower end,
but because they're working their way up. That's why
they had lower end wrestlers that were around the entire convention. But like the main people that were inside, you had to have the specific ticket for, and those tickets were a lot.
Did you get any of that?
Higher? No, they were a lot higher price. I didn't even buy those. I just bought a general admission.
Oh, okay.
But like, those ran like for. Did you guess? But then they swapped out people. They swapped out like the people that were supposed to be there that I seen when I was ordering tickets, weren't the people that were there when I went. Like they swapped them around and
that
stuff. Sucks. I'd be like, oh man, I would be super
that
pissed.
Sucked. I'm sure they may warn you about that. Like if you were to pay.
Yeah,
I don't know.
Well, what happened with The Rock on Monday night? He was supposed to be there. They advertised him super heavy. He was on the fucking screens outside and everything.
Yeah.
And then he ended up not being there. And they said it at the beginning of the show. They didn't offer refunds or anything like that. But like they booed the shit out of it.
Yeah.
Can you hear for the crowd? It's insane.
So we had like I'm trying to think of what was I the first night I went there, I said I wasn't gonna go over there and you know not go to fucking Times Square, so I wanted to go to Times Square. So the first night we got over there, it was pretty early because like I tried to match up times with his train and my plane, so we got there pretty early. So when we went to Times Square, it was pretty easy to get to Times Square. I took a ferry, and in Times Square, that shit is fucking packed, like, at all times.
Well, yeah.
All times it's fucking packed, I guess.
Yeah, it's tourism city, like,
yeah.
You'll see everybody.
But the thing is, there's not much, I don't know, it seemed like every other store was, like, one of those, like, I love NY places.
It's
like,
boring.
It
wasn't. It's boring. Like,
there was a lot of street performers, a lot of shit like that.
That's just about any place that's a tourist attraction.
It leads me into the fucking Cookie Monster thing. Like, so they have mascots and, like, people in mascot costumes. And, like, to be honest, the mascot costumes are pretty cool. Like, they look. They're pretty good costumes.
Okay.
Like, it was a Cookie Monster, and I wanted that costume because it was like a legit Cookie Monster mascot outfit.
The Blue Monster costume?
It wasn't the Blue Monster.
What, that
legit,
panda?
It was legit.
Did
like,
you ask him?
Terrifying.
How you got about it?
No, they were like super packed. So, I mean, I was just taking pictures of like all of them that were kind of roaming around. They had like an Elmo. There was a Statue of Liberty. There was a SpongeBob. There was like, there's fucking people all over the place. And like, I seen the Cookie Monster, and I was like, I gotta at least get a picture with him. So I went up to him. And this is pretty sad, but like I hear a lot of them talking in the mascot outfits, and they're all Spanish. They're all Spanish.
How is that sad? They're trying to get the hustle.
They're all trying. Yeah, they're all trying to get a tip and stuff like that. But literally, all of them are Spanish there.
It's fine. New York is very Spanish oriented. You should know this already. Yeah, there's a lot of Latinos there.
The working people are, I guess.
Like, the working people. Okay.
Yeah. Because there was a lot of white people there too. What are you talking about?
Well, isn't there like a cowboy with like some like
the naked cowboy?
Yeah, wait.
Seen him.
I seen the naked
cowboy. He's a black guy.
He's a black guy.
Yeah.
Last time I saw him,
I got a hilarious picture of him because the security people were staring at him, and he was just sitting there like thrusting while he was playing his like banjo thing, and they're just looking at him, and he just keeps going. Like, shit, like whatever. Then there, so I go up to the Cookie Monster and I'm asking him for a picture, and he's like, "Yeah, sure." And I get a picture with him.
Wait, he didn't say it like that. How he said it?
He's like,
"Si, si, senor."
Si, senor.
That's what he said.
There you go. You're gonna make fun of him. Make fun of it all the way.
Make fun of him. I'm just saying that it's like it's weird that like everybody in those costumes are all like,
"Si, senor, soy monstruo de galleta."
They wanted some tips.
Some porque. Dinero.
Yeah.
I told him.
I said.
Donde está dinero?
After he got me the picture or whatever, I was gonna give him a tip. And then all of a sudden, like out of nowhere, my cousin's taking a picture of me and the Cookie Monster. He gets the picture, and all of a sudden, out of nowhere, an Elmo and a Dora come up, and they're like, no, 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 one more, one more, one more. And I'm like, all right, whatever. I mean, I'll take a fucking another picture. All right, whatever. So they, like, get on the ends, and, like, it's like, me, Cookie Monster, Elmo, and Dora.
Dora.
The Explorer.
Full-blown mascot Dora.
Really? Like, big old head?
Yeah, big head.
Holy shit.
Where did you get the
money
for that one, man? And then, like...
I want a Dora outfit.
So I take the picture, and then afterwards, they fucking, like, convulge into me, and they're like, you know, tips. I'm like... I'm not giving fucking tips to all of you. I was like, I'm giving a tip to the Cookie Monster because he's the one that I asked a picture for. So I gave the money to the Cookie Monster, and then the fucking door's like coming up. He's like, you got any more? I was like, I got any more. I'm sorry. Like, I just,
you know what I just picture? I just picture Finding Nemo when all the seagulls, my.
Yeah. They all fucking came up like to try to get a tip off of it. I was just like, I asked for fucking Cookie Monster. But then it turns out like when I got back here, I told my mom the story. And then my mom sent me an article that says Cookie Monster in Times Square arrested for pushing, like, a 2-year-old or something.
Wow. Groping or something like that.
Yeah, no, I think it was the Elmo that got arrested. I don't know. Yeah, yeah.
He got to use the tip money for bail.
There you go.
You helped him get out of jail.
I was like, at least I got a picture of him.
Before he went to prison.
Before he fucking
You got a picture of Cookie Monster on its prime.
Yeah.
Before the meltdown.
I could have played a better cookie than him. Pushing little kids and shit, giving them trauma to their head, pushing them on the ground and stuff.
No tip.
So after we walked the entire Times Square strip or whatever, which was pretty long, I got to take like pictures of like, it was funny because when me and my cousin were there, like I wasn't thinking, whoa, like I'm here at Times Square. I'm thinking, man, I died here in GTA. like there's the subway that we went down in GTA. They had the American flag part, like where it's sticking out and everything. And I'm like, man, I was there in GTA. I fucking skydived off
that building. Hit that bus off that building.
That's all I was making comparisons to. I was like, man, this is like.
You know what? When I go to New York and I go into, I just like try so hard to not look like a fucking tourist.
I had the camera around. I looked like Dan with the camera.
Do you have a fanny pack?
I had like it was on the side.
One of the visors.
Yeah, like a golf visor and a fanny pack.
I hate the idea of going to New York
because
they shit on tourists.
I don't like being acting like a tourist.
I asked, the minute I got out of the airport, I asked this lady, the lady that was there for the cabs or whatever, and I was like, you know, I want to go to this hotel. And she's like, she starts saying like a city name. She's like, Weehawken. And I'm like, what? She's like, in Weehawken. I'm like, I don't know. In Weehawken! And I'm like... Why the fuck are you getting mad? Like, why are you getting mad with me? I'm like, let me pull up the address real quick. Yeah, it's in Weehawken. It's like, fill it out and stuff. I'm like, Jesus.
Like shit, so like, that's why I try like so hard. Anytime
anywhere I'm at a place that has tourists, I try my best to not be a tourist.
Just make fun of them.
My best.
Kutra, are you aware that you're like the most tourist-looking motherfucker in the world?
No, I don't give a shit. Like, fuck that. If I look like a tourist or whatever, then I'll act like that. And then I expect them to help me then. If I look like a tourist, help me out.
No, they're annoyed by you.
I don't give a
shit. They get annoyed
by
you.
If I'm paying them, help me out.
And they
you're stimulating their economy.
I know.
Yeah. Help you out.
But they get angry. I go with that mentality. I'm like, I'm helping you. Most likely, I'm overpaying for whatever I'm doing.
Yeah, you know damn right they're overcharging.
Treat me like a person, you piece of shit.
But take my money, but you treat me like shit.
Yeah, it's just an abusive relationship. I don't like it.
So the goal after was obviously to get out of Times Square. and getting out of Times Square.
Wait, did you not go to Nintendo World or whatever? Did you not check all that shit?
Nintendo World, I don't think, is in Times Square.
I thought it was around there.
It's around there.
Is it around there?
I thought it was.
I thought it was a really big building, though. It's not...
Actually, think about...
I went to, like, the M&M's World and shit.
M&M's way bigger than it. It's not that big, actually. I felt like, for all that hype they give Nintendo World, it's not that
big. Yeah, I thought that they gave it, like, a few floors and stuff.
It has two floors, and it's, like, the first floor is just all Pokemon, and then...
I didn't see any Nintendo thing. Yeah. On the actual main thing.
No, it's not there.
Probably
it's
selling a lot of Wii U's there. Yeah. I'll tell you what. Selling a lot of them.
They had like people, they had a crazy big Toys R Us that was in the middle.
Oh, yeah. The Ferris wheel?
Yeah. That's and then they had like, they had dudes that were in there freaking yelling with microphones trying to sell shit. Like the stupidest shit they were trying to sell. Like some stupid like, blocks, building blocks or whatever, and they're like, you can do this.
Oh my God.
like, yeah, come buy it. And I was just like, I don't
know. Everyone has that, all the tourists have their money, like,
oh, yeah, yeah, yeah,
buy.
I'll buy it if it's exclusive to New York. Yeah,
I love NY on it, I'll take it.
New York Monopoly, here you go.
Jesus Christ. So we were trying to get out of there. So we go straight, like, up to the top. Like, I guess we started at the bottom of Times Square, and we went up to the top to get, like, out of it. And we were looking for a cab, but, like, literally every cab that's going towards Times Square is dropping someone off in Times Square. So there's not, like... It's hard. You do have to be a dick.
In New York, you have to be a dick.
In Jersey and fucking New York, you have to be a dickhead, at least a bit of a dickhead, because I kept losing my cousin, and I was like... I was telling him, I was like, you gotta be a little bit of a dick. You gotta push people and shit like that to get the fuck through.
You need to act like royalty. You need to think that everybody's like below you in New York. Yeah.
It's so sad.
They will shit on you, and then they'll cook you, and then
it's like
eat
tank
you
respect.
And then shit you again.
It's like tank respect. You know, you're a dick to them, they're a dick to you. It's like respect, tank respect.
I don't know about that. They got some new level of respect.
I meant it's the same. You respect the tank if you're a tank. If you're a dick, you respect the other dick. He's a dick. I'm going to give him some respect. Come on through.
I got you.
All right, good.
And then they help you when you're a dick to them.
Yeah. They're like, oh, yeah, okay.
It's one of us.
We're on the same page.
One of us.
So we were trying to find a cab or whatever, I was like, you know, it would probably be best to find a hotel in the area because hotels have the taxis that stop in front of them, and we can just take one. And I was like, you know, that would probably be a lot easier than standing here looking like a dickhead waiting for a cab and then, you know, waving to them, and then they fucking turn out to always have somebody in there. So I seen a hotel, which was the name of this. It was the same hotel that we stayed at, except different location. So I figured I could pull out my card to that hotel and be like, you know, I have a room here. Give me a cab or something like that. I was gonna try to be slick with it, but we went over there and there was this real asshole in a fucking cab. Like, there's a guy in a cab just sitting there on his phone, and I go up to him and I'm like, you know, are you taking anybody? He just kind of like looks at me while he's on the phone, and then he just like looks forward again and just keeps talking. I'm like, oh, okay, well, I guess, you know, he's not taking anybody.
So he smashes window and walk away.
I backed up, and an old lady came up and asked the same thing. Like, are you taking anybody? He looked at her. He starts putting up his window. And she fucking walked up like he started putting up his window. So I guess he eventually left. I don't know. So then we went over to like the...
Maybe he
was
just having a bad day.
I don't fucking know. Maybe that phone call was happening.
Maybe he got fired on that phone call.
Maybe he just has to fucking take trips to Times Square all the goddamn time. So he's really upset.
Yeah.
But so I was asking like the bellkeeper guy or whatever, the dude that usually calls the taxis.
Concierge.
Like, yeah.
Concierge.
I went up to like him and I guess he was already calling cabs for other people, so I just kind of stood in line and waited. And he eventually called one for us, and the cab comes up and pulls in to like the hotel.
Okay.
And me and my cousin we're getting into the cab. Like, I'm literally pretty much in the back seat.
Okay.
All of a sudden this cop starts like yelling and stuff. He's like, "Hey, hey." And I look over at him and he's like signaling to get out. He's like, "No, like get out of the car."
Why?
I don't know. I was thinking like something was wrong with the driver. I thought like maybe like this driver was like someone he recognized and he was going to get busted or something like that. But he comes up. He starts yelling at the concierge guy and he's like, you know, "You can't be doing that. You got all this room here. You got to utilize it. You can't be having the taxis like that far out into the street or whatever."
Really?
And then he was like, "Go." And he was yelling at the taxi driver to go. Like, he told him to leave. So the taxi left, and me and my cousin were like, "That was our fucking cab. We just were sitting here for like 30 minutes waiting for a cab, and you just told him to leave." And then he goes back, the cop goes back and starts like, you know, just having a phone call or whatever. And then another cab comes in, almost does the same exact thing. So I'm like, oh, he's going to fucking come over again. But I look over and that cop is gone. Like, he fucking left immediately after doing that. I thought that he was going to like stand around and
do his job.
Yeah. And just like watch to see if he fucks up again or something like that. But he just left. Like, he was just being a dick just to be a dick. So then we got in the cab.
He booked out his quota for the day.
Yeah.
Just being a dick quota.
He got you and your cousin.
Yeah.
He's done for the day.
Then the concierge guy.
I'm gonna go to my wife and yell at her now. That's why he's kind of.
when we got in the cab or whatever, the concierge guy, he's like, you know, fucking prick cop. I was about to slap him in the face. It's like, oh, he didn't want to fight a cop, but I mean,
well, yeah, it was funny though. Cop, you lose already.
I was just like, holy shit, like this is fucking ridiculous. So we got out of there, like, and I was like, I ain't going back to Times Square. That was a bitch and a half to get
it's
in and get out.
It. Like, I thought, you know, I had that mentality ever since I moved here to the States. Everybody's like, just praise us, New York. And I'm like, New York is a great place, you know, it is. But for someone that just like wants to like have a good time, it gets so chaotic sometimes. It just like you completely.
There was a dude screaming for a cop, and I'm imagining that somebody robbed him or something like that. But he was like, cop, cop, cop. He like kept running down the street, like looking for a cop.
I think New York is the second or the first biggest place for iPhones robbery. Like people will.
Just pickpockets in general, tourist attractions.
Well, because everyone has those booths, like with the I Love New York shirt and stuff. They're just like sitting out. It's like the hot dog stands in GTA. Yep, just people just come up and take whatever the fuck, and then they leave. And like,
fucking annoying.
Jesus,
you gotta be a real shark to live in New York. You need to have a shark mentality.
I was saying that there was this guy that had a little booth, a little table where he's selling shit, and he had a bubble gun, and he was just blowing bubbles. And I was like, I don't want to go up there because I don't want to cut through his bubbles. He might yell at me. But like, hey, he was doing it wrong anyway. He had the fucking bubble gun like upside down, and he was like still shooting it anyway. But he was like dancing with it, like he was shooting the bubbles, and he just started like dancing with it. And I was like, man, he must be really into fucking these bubbles. Like he's like shooting bubbles and dancing and stuff. He's not wearing a headset or anything like that. So he's listening.
Music was in his head.
It's in his
head. Yeah. The bubbles made him. Damn.
Yeah, he just started jiving with those bubbles. It's like, what the fuck?
So, what happened?
Then also, someone tried to give me their demo there.
For what?
That happens like all over.
This is like typical tourist.
And I was like, no, I'm okay. He was like, come on, don't be scared of a black man.
Did he really say that?
Did you take it after?
No. Oh. I wouldn't take it.
Like, oh, okay. Well.
You have to seriously walk through. Like, that was... It was
no eye contact.
50 or 60 of them in one spot in at Venice Beach, and Lyle took me there. You have to ignore. You cannot make eye contact. You have to
They kept stopping my cousin. I was
one.
Like, just keep going.
Yeah, if
like,
you have someone
not.
With you that stops and, like, makes eye contact, you're done, because they're going to feast off of that.
I was just like, don't
swarm,
look at
swarm.
Him. Just keep going. Just keep going.
Like, oh, he's
stopped. Charles, get him! I like it.
He's
I
just like looking around all clueless and shit, and they just go up to him, and I'm just like, oh,
you want to listen to my demo room, man.
You were thinking about music, right? Here it is, man.
Trying to give you, there was like at least 10 fucking people that came up to us with comedy, stand-up comedy shows. They're like, you like comedy? I was like, no, don't like it. You don't like comedy? Come on. No, I don't like comedy. Sorry.
I don't like to laugh.
Joy just makes me so upset.
I don't like comedy, but your attempt to give me that card is pretty funny. That would be a dickhead thing to say. So then, yeah, the next day we had WrestleMania, so we tried to get there as early as possible.
Yeah, it was probably
and,
packed.
It was
How
funny because they had.
I don't know much about the wrestling scene. I haven't been, but like, it's.
I don't know. We got there pretty early, so I mean, we were. The thing is with the, it's a lot more organized at the MetLife Stadium than it is the Izod Center, because the Izod Center, when we were doing access, they have, for some reason, all of their entrances closed off. One entrance that you can go in. And
smart.
Out of the one entrance, only four of the doors. So there's like eight doors there. There's only open four of them.
Man, these people
smart.
Are thinking.
They know what they're doing. They know
so they have
doing.
One
Congestion.
Line.
What?
One line coming out of the, like, I could try to, like, draw, like, a thing. Like, if you say, like, there's the door. The line comes out from the door and goes back to the parking lot. Then once it gets to the parking lot, they decided, because they can't have people in the parking lot or whatever. They can't do that.
That's
they would loop the line back around.
Oh, no.
So the line, it was kind of making like a penis, where the actual end of the line was like up towards the front of the line.
Really?
So you can imagine what happened. Then they finally decided to take the line, like eventually they started to take it up that way, like towards the parking lot, like wrapping around it.
Okay.
But originally, they took the line back and then around. Yeah, look at that. It looks retarded.
It looks like saggy ass balls.
It's terrible.
So then, you know what happens when they finally start calling people in? this line merges with that line, yep. And everyone just goes straight, and everyone's bitching about it, and they're like, these weren't the same people I was next to for the past, like, 5 hours, or whatever. And I was one of them. I was one of the people on the other line. I just merged it. I fucking went out. I said that to my cousin. I was like, what the fuck are they doing with this line? I was like, what is stopping me from merging into this line and just going up with them? What's stopping me from doing that? Nothing. And I did it. And I was just like, fuck that. People behind me bitching, and I was just like,
should have had the idea first.
Just blank them. That's the best thing.
I mean, I know you were sitting there. Yeah, you were sitting there for 5 hours. I mean, I was sitting there for 5 minutes. And I got to the same spot as you.
Ain't that a bitch.
They were really pissed about that. But, yeah, I didn't understand. Their line format, didn't they do the same shit with the Monday Night Raw at the Izod Center? It's like their lines are so fucking stupid with how they organize that. I don't understand that. On top of that, I was saying to you when I got back that the arenas themselves, they look good on the outside.
Okay.
Go around to the back. There's fucking dirty ass shit, construction, garbage, random ass shit behind the arenas. Like, it's
well,
like,
I think that's what most. Well, not most.
No,
but you always you see you.
There, the it's always back. Downtown, yeah. So there's a chance that yeah. You know it has some of that stuff. But
I asked like every cab driver that took us over there. I was asking them. I was like, why would they do like two arenas right next to each other? I was like, that's got to be super fucking chaotic to have a big dome arena there, and then just like, you know, the little arena there, you're hiding. But they're literally, they share like a parking lot and shit. Like
they do?
Well, I don't know if they like share a parking lot, but like they're, it's probably one street that divides them. Like it's ridiculous how close they are. You literally take a tunnel to go back and forth between them.
Really?
Yeah, it's just like a walkway to go back and forth. Like you could park in the Izod Center parking lot and you just take a tunnel right over to the MetLife Stadium. It's just like,
I'm sure they
it's so fucking congested and stuff. It's so ridiculous how they did that. I don't understand why they did that.
So I have a question. How was the matches? How was WrestleMania?
Oh, so we went to WrestleMania.
I want to know. I know about the parking lot. I know about Times Square. Yeah. What about the matches? What about the wrestling?
The set itself was really good.
Was it?
It was really good. It was.
What was it first?
So supposedly they said that the set itself cost them like $90,000 or something like that. Yeah. So I was saying we could pull together and we could build something like that.
Dude,
we could build a fucking Statue of Liberty replica and just have it somewhere. Have it on top of the house or something.
Have it in the yard.
Yeah. Have it right there at the window, so it just appears.
Yeah. Looking into the neighbors.
HOA would love that.
So right. I was sitting in the corner, like I was sitting like right by like where the timekeeper, like the ring bell person is, and like it was pretty much just a dead spot. Like I couldn't be seen on camera or anything like that. But it was like a good spot to see what was going on, but it was also the spot where like there was always a security asshole there to be like, you can't go up to the barricade or whatever and, you know, like smack on the side or anything like that. There was a guy in the front row that was fucking doing it like crazy. This guy, he was I don't want to call him an asshole.
He was a hardcore fan.
But like he was just way too
into it,
trying to be into the crowd, like he was
trying to get the crowd riled
up. He would stand up and shit, and he would be like, come on, like he started raising his hands up, start clapping and shit, and we're like, no, no one's fucking giving you a reaction. He kept doing it like 5 or 6 times. Like, nobody is starting to chant along with you, just sit down, because he kept standing up every time he'd do it. And there was a little kid right next to him. It was just like, don't be a prick. If the kid is right there, he's trying to see, and you're standing up being like, hey, come on, yeah. And
it's like, that's a real sports fan. You are not
fucking a dick. So the front row they had set up so that way the front row would be, I guess, for the wrestler's family, so they were constantly swapping people in and out.
Okay.
So they were there, like the family would be there, I guess, for their you know, their relatives fight. Match. Yeah, mm-hmm. And then they'd swap out and then have someone else come in.
Cool.
The matches themselves, they weren't, like, I don't know. It felt, like, really, really underdone, like, for
really?
WrestleMania.
For
yeah.
WrestleMania?
I mean, it was my first one, and it was my first pay-per-view in general, but it didn't, for the price and shit, like, it didn't seem like it was all that. Like, it wasn't.
That sucks.
It wasn't, like, a big
spectacle. Because I remember watching WrestleMania when I was a little kid, and I was like, I wish I was there. This would be 10 times better now that you actually...
Well, the thing is, like on TV, the arenas look a lot bigger than what they do in person. Okay. Like the arenas are a lot smaller in person than what you see.
Wouldn't that
TV.
Mean that you get to see the
No, I'm just saying, like, usually, like with WrestleMania, they have like I know in the years past, it'd make it seem like the wrestlers had like a really long ramp that they have to walk down.
Oh yeah.
But it's really not that long.
Really?
Like it's really not that long.
So they walk really slow then.
Somewhat. Undertaker's entrance took like forever.
Oh, like a 20-minute entrance.
It was really cool at the beginning though, because he had like zombies coming up, like reaching at his feet. That was really cool.
Really?
Like, he had like hands coming through the stage, like reaching at him and shit, like while he was walking.
Oh,
down.
That is legit.
But then he took like an extra 15 minutes. Yeah,
okay. So it's like, is he the one?
Kind of plays it out.
Which one is Kane? The one that which Undertaker?
Kane
one
has
that,
the pyro in the ring.
Yeah, pyro in the ring, and he's the outside, right? Or not?
His was like at the entrance, like he had fire at the entrance.
Okay, cool. Cause that would have been cool. Kane wasn't in that.
The pyros and all that. Yeah, Kane was there.
Oh, cool.
The pyro and everything was really cool. All that. It just seemed like the crowd was really dead. The crowd wasn't.
Really?
But again, a lot of people were saying that was because it's an open stadium, so the sound just goes right out.
And like, oh, okay.
Like you couldn't really get much going, but it just like they didn't. It was super predictable. Like everything that you would read that like people were like, this is supposed to happen, happened. Like it wasn't. There was no like, you know.
They didn't throw a bone.
Yeah, no swerves or anything like that. Nothing different as opposed to like what you would read that.
What was the best fight? In the whole WrestleMania, which one was like the best one?
Punk and Undertaker, even though that I guess came out. It's different seeing it live than what it was, I guess, on TV, because people were saying that the Triple H Lesnar match was really slow on TV.
Really?
But live, it didn't seem that slow at all. Like, I don't know, it didn't seem all that slow. That was the one that I yelled at. Like, I yelled,
"You killed him!"
That was the one I yelled at. I tried to keep doing that. I was like, you know, stop, you're hurting him, and shut it down. Like, I kept trying to yell that. But I guess the crowd was so dead in that moment that you could actually hear me on that one.
You could.
Yeah.
You found the video, right?
But,
the way, just as not me being a like hardcore wrestling fan compared to you, I would know already if you put Punk against Undertaker, I would assume right off the bat Undertaker was gonna win.
Yeah.
Especially with a streak.
They didn't have enough.
How old is fucking
Undertaker? Probably like 50.
Like 60 years old or so.
Something, probably. I don't know.
Was like in shape? Was he able to like actually like match?
I guess he's got more shit going on with like his bones and stuff where he's getting like surgery and stuff.
Yeah, they're probably screwed
like hip
up.
Surgery and
he's
shit
been doing
like
it for like 20-30 years.
Yeah, but he doesn't.
That's the only match like he does. Like,
yeah,
all
he's
year
not
round.
Consistent though. He just, yeah, he
but he was consistent for a while. Yeah, like when he was younger, that'll screw you up. It's like
so
football.
He only does WrestleMania then.
For now, like for the most part, yeah, kind of.
So
I mean,
so
he might do some
more. One then.
Yeah.
Damn, I don't. That doesn't make sense, because Punk is, like, so much more, like fit, but
I don't think anyone will. Like, I gave up, like, trying to think that someone would beat him a couple years ago. I don't know.
Yeah, I'm just saying.
There wasn't that much back and forth with this one as there was, like, with what they did with, like, Edge and other people. They had more back and forth, like, where it was like, oh, we might lose.
Same
but
thing
this one, it was
Triple
like...
Triple H had, like, his downs and then his ups, too, I remember.
Yeah, and Triple H, like, people were saying, like, that... Like, logically, I thought he would lose, but he didn't.
Yeah, because maybe, like, pass the throne to somebody else, pass the
didn't.
Torch, you know?
They don't do that.
What the fuck?
Well, Lesnar's got his, like, MMA thing, so...
It was pretty funny that we tried to get, like, both times at Raw and at WrestleMania, we were trying to get people to throw back Cena's shit, because he'd throw out his hat. And he threw out his hat. Someone did throw it back after we were chanting at him to throw it back. And then he threw it specifically at a Cena fan so that way they would keep it. Like he started doing that. He threw it specifically at his fans that are wearing his gear and stuff so that way they would keep it. And like he didn't want another case where everyone was throwing his shit back.
Yep.
Really?
Yeah.
Why? Since when did Cena become so hated?
Because he's been so stale for the past few years, so it's just like...
He just appeals to, like, kids for the most part.
It's funny, though, because if they were to turn him bad or whatever and everybody would cheer for him, like, then it would be kind of the opposite. Like, I don't know. Like, he's in the spot right now where it's like, he gets his cheers, he's got his fan base and stuff like that, but he like, plays both roles pretty much. Because he'll play up when the crowd is hating him. Like, at Monday, like, he was playing it up because no one liked him. He was getting boos and shit like crazy. So he just kind of takes it in and like, he uses it in some places.
Yeah. That's smart of him.
But they just started doing that with him. Like, they didn't used to do that. Like,
yeah,
they used to try to, like, force him, like, force it. And they don't really do that anymore. Like, if he's getting booed, he'll be like, you know, try to play off the crowd and stuff like that, so.
He's done enough movies.
Shitty movies.
Yeah.
Are you kidding me?
Yeah. Him yeah, there was
and
like
Stone Cold. and The Rock to combine into one movie.
Oh my god. That is one unbeatable.
It would still flop. It would be
amazing. It'd be amazing.
Yeah, I think it would flop, actually.
So they cut a match off of WrestleMania. There was supposed to be a match that they cut off. It was with, what's his name? Fucking Funkosaurus or whatever.
Funkosaurus?
Yeah.
What the
fuck is that? It was like a 6-man tag or whatever, or an 8-man tag. And it wasn't really a good match or whatever, but like, I heard them rehearsing it when we were outside the arena, and I guess they cut it, but they had a P. Diddy performance. Man.
Wait, what?
P. Diddy.
P. Diddy.
P. Diddy performed.
Like the actual rapper, not somebody pretending to be.
No, the actual Diddy Diddy.
That sounds
Papa
really good.
Diddy.
P. Diddy Kong?
Did you see the limo?
No, he didn't go.
Actually,
should have came out in the limo.
That's P. Diddy! Yeah. That's what I got.
I think they wasted all
so
their
P.
fucking.
So P. Diddy rap in the.
Yeah, it was like a musical performance.
Really? Since when did they do that?
I don't know.
That's Saturday Night Live.
A couple years ago, they started doing like musical performances. They never really go over too well.
Now, the...
I think they wasted all their pyro on him because like he was getting fireworks all over the place. Like,
oh, yeah.
Was it... Okay, so was it Raw or WrestleMania that the seat free next to you, and then that guy that ran up and
that was WrestleMania,
and then...
So I had the guy that was on my my cousin's left. He was pissed off the entire night. He was just an angry guy.
Bad night. Bad
like
night.
I guess he didn't like the way the night was going or whatever, and he hated both Rock and Cena. And he would try to do this move where he would throw up a peace sign. And he wanted them to look at the peace sign, and then he'd quick switch it to a middle finger. He just wanted to, like, throw up middle fingers. And he was constantly flicking them off and shit. Like, he was just an angry person.
Wow.
And he was so mad. He was, like, chanting, fuck you, and stuff, to be Diddy and stuff. He was, like, saying, what is this shit? Like, he was just an angry guy.
Well, you know what?
And I didn't understand it. He was yelling, like, fuck you both at Rock and Cena when they were both out there. I was, like, I'm thinking, like, why'd you even stay for the main event? You don't like them both. Like, what the fuck? What are you doing? Like, just leave a while. But I guess he wanted the chair, the WrestleMania chair, because the first few rows get to take your chair home with you. So I guess he wanted a chair, so he stayed. But he was angry. But then there was a guy behind me, and for I want to say maybe the first two or three matches, because I was seat two and my cousin was seat three.
Okay.
And seat one was, you know, somebody. First two or three matches. Seat one, that guy never came. He wasn't there. I was like, "What the fuck is this guy?" Like, I'm just gonna like, I was just sitting in his seat for the most part, and I had my bag and shit on mine. I was just taking his seat, and then he finally came in at like the third match, and so I moved over or whatever. But gradually, like as the night went on, through matches and stuff, he kept leaving. He would constantly disappear, and I'd look over and I'd be like,
"He's a superhero."
He flew out of the stadium.
I'm out.
I need help. New York.
He wanted to go get some like chicken fingers. Came back with chicken fingers and then he left because he had to go to the bathroom again. Or
had
something
to get
like
something
that.
To drink.
He was constantly
I'm
gone.
I'm feeling Monday today. Oh no!
Wow.
I'm so sorry. I'm
wow.
That is my ringtone.
I don't know. What's worse, the ringtone or
having
to go off during a.
She can wait.
Unbelievable.
I'm sorry. I was thinking about the guy flying to get Wendy's.
So anyway, there was this guy behind, in the row behind, where they were getting pretty aggravated that, like, people kept standing up. Which, I mean, it was a gimme when you're fucking there. Like, the people that are on the floor, they're all on one level.
Mm-hmm.
So it's pretty much based on, like, height. These fuckers that were in front of, like, me and my cousin, they were pretty goddamn tall. Like, it was, like, a 15-year-old that was, like, not as tall as the guy from the fucking Creature Meetup.
Yeah.
But, like, he was still pretty tall that I couldn't be like,
that dude was huge. The one from Creature Meetup?
Yeah. I was still trying to, like, look around and try to get over him and stuff. Ugh.
We had that problem when we went to Raw. People kept standing up in front of us.
Every time. It's because everyone's on one level or whatever.
Yeah, it sucks.
In some cases, it's better to have the lower bowl seats where, like, once you stand up, you're guaranteed to, like, be above him.
Yeah,
the person's super fucking tall. But, like, the guys behind us couldn't see, and they kept saying, like, you know, sit down. And I was just like, I'm not fucking sitting down unless the people in front of me are sitting down. It's up to the people in the front row to sit down, and then everyone else sits down.
Yeah.
It's like, if everyone's standing up, then I'm going to stand up, too, so I can fucking see. And the guy that kept standing up behind me kept getting yelled at by security. Like, they would be like, you know, you got to sit down. You got to sit down. And the guy was like, but there's no one behind me. Like, it was a foreign guy. He's like, there's no one behind me. And it was like, it was just like a speaker or whatever that was behind him. It was like, you know, kind of legit that there was no one really there behind yeah. him. It was pretty much a speaker. But they kept telling him to sit the fuck down.
That's racist.
And the one time, like, they must have like, they must have had like two or three different people like yell at him to sit down. And then finally, like, the fourth guy came up to him, and it was an actual like WWE security guy. And he kept saying, he was like, you know, there's no one behind me. And the guy was like, you know, I'm WWE security. I'm telling you to sit down. He was like, but there's no one behind me. And he was like, it doesn't matter. Sit down. And he was like, but there's no one behind me. And the guy's like, do you have a question? Because if not, sit down. And like, the guy was just getting really upset. He was just like, he's just sitting down. Aww, and stuff. He's just like,
that's sad.
That poor guy.
Pay for that to get to.
Well, he eventually, the motherfucker eventually moved up to my seat one. That was where next
to me. Oh, is that it?
Yeah.
The superhero seat.
He eventually moved up to sit next to me. Seat. Yeah, yeah. Yeah. It was funny.
Did he steal the chair too?
No, I tried to steal the chair. When we were leaving, I fucking...
I'm so proud of you. You made us Puerto Rican feel so
I fucking
good.
Had two chairs on my side or whatever, and he was like... The guy comes up, some security guy comes up, but he's just like, you know, you got two tickets? And I was like, yeah, well, his ticket, my cousin was next to me or whatever, and he was just like, you know, that would be three then. So it would be like, he was like, well, what do you get the extra chair from? I was like, my guy left, like the guy that was next to me left. He's like, oh, well, this stays with me then. And he took the other chair from me. And I was like, no.
My chair.
I'm glad, though.
This
I'm glad.
I tried to get it. I tried
to
get it.
I'm glad that the dude that was having a bad time got to sit next to you.
Yeah, he got to move up.
Move up and then sit.
Fuck him. He could have ended up paying that one row difference. Probably could have been a few grand, where he probably paid a little bit less than me, and then he got to sit next to me.
But it's like the line thing, like the 5 minute, 5 hour thing. So
I mean, it's the same thing. Like, if I seen an empty seat, I would have took advantage and fucking went to there.
Hey, you made his day. You were cool with him.
I didn't say anything bad. You know, I should have told him, get the fuck back to your seat, man. My cousin comes here.
Make sure to
every
stay
once
seated
in a while.
Too, when you're back.
That was good karma again. Like when we gave that pizza to the old lady.
Yeah.
It was good karma, man.
Well, I was bummed out from the show in general anyway. So I was like, fuck it. He can have it. Whatever.
Whatever. Just sit
you
there.
You made his day. And yeah.
I
hero.
Made his day.
You're a hero. And then he got to Sheamus. He got to sit.
He got sitting next to
next to a YouTube.
Real
star.
Question is, did wow. you see DSP there?
No.
Could have met up with him and stuff.
No.
Talked about wrestling.
I did have a lot of fans though. That
really?
I mean, there was a good like maybe 10 to 15 or so fans that seen me there. And considering I don't really do that much wrestling stuff nowadays,
yeah.
It was pretty funny that I had that many like come up to me and stuff. And I was being like I was saying on Twitter, I was being like really. In like I was like casual, like I wasn't really yelling or anything like that.
Yeah.
Like I wasn't looking
attention.
Until I bought the hat at WrestleMania. I bought a hat and it was like a really goofy looking hat with a mohawk on it and stuff. Then I looked kind of goofy.
Then it was just a cry for attention.
Yeah.
Man, no one's recognized me.
Bam, mohawk.
Is that Nova?
A lot of people would, like, I guess I would say one thing to my cousin, and somehow they heard it, and they'd be like, I know that voice, and they would come up to
I
me.
I know that voice.
Yeah, something like that.
They sniff out the voice, really?
Yeah, I guess.
I can smell it.
I smell that
bloodhounds.
So I get the WrestleMania chair. I come back,
man.
And now it's a mission to try to get it back here. And I'm like,
oh, that was the whole box thing. Wasn't
yeah,
it?
That was the whole box thing.
I was wondering.
So I figure that the hotel, like, they can cover it and they can, you know, they can ship it out because we've done that at Comic-Con.
Yeah, we did that.
A bunch of shit mm-hmm. back. Yep. So I figured that would be good. And I go down and I ask the guy, and he's like, you know, we can ship it for you and everything. We just need a box. You need to have a box for it. And I'm just like, where the
Damn.
Fuck am I gonna get a box? But then I remember
did
we went
check behind
the
WrestleMania. Stadium.
We went. They probably would. Yeah, they would. The boxes that the chairs come
Fruity
in.
Pebbles
yeah.
box.
Yeah.
It's a big one.
They had what's it called? There were two mail offices like that were. One was pretty close, like walkable, that
okay.
I knew I could get to because we had what was it that we were trying to? I think we were trying to find something to eat or something like that. No, we got dropped off at the wrong fucking bay thing, like, cause we,
GG.
Yeah, yeah, like, when we're, the fucking ferry thing comes back, and it stops at, like, just 2 points or whatever, and they don't give you any time, again, back to the dickhead thing. If you don't
yeah.
get the fuck out, when it, right when it docks, because there was, like, maybe two people that got on, they're fucking gone.
Yeah.
So it was, like, you got, you got like 5 second window. Get the fuck out. You know what? Or you're gonna have to go to the next stop.
Your life is hard to live.
Yeah. It was at that moment.
New York life is hard.
It's like hard mode in New York.
They're playing New impossible.
Life yeah. Like, come on, man, give me a break.
So when we it was funny because when we were walking back from the other dock or whatever, because it wasn't a ways away, but it was maybe like a few blocks away. Mm-hmm. And we started walking over there. That's when I had seen a few playgrounds. There were some playgrounds.
Did it remind of us when we were doing our thing?
No.
No, I guess not.
There was playgrounds. There were kids like frolicking around and stuff like that.
Frolicking. And, yeah, like, yeah. Were there a lot of daisies?
A lot of skipping.
Yeah, they skipping, were, you know, jump doing ropes. Their stuff, doing all that shit. Uh-huh. Immediately behind the playground is a building torn in half with construction going on right there.
Huh. Nails the raining from the sky in the playground. And loads of sparks and metal in the sky.
I got an amazing picture of this little girl playing, and right behind her is like a bulldozer like running through a building. And it was just like, what a perfect place for a playground.
You know what? They're already building. The parents are already building the kids to not give a fuck.
Yeah,
so that girl's like, bulldozer, I'm suing your ass if something happens.
Fuck it, I'm playing in the sand. Yeah. You have to wait.
So you know where I grew up?
Finding like rusted nails and bolts and stuff in the sand.
Oh, just eat them.
Yeah.
What?
Just eat them.
What kind of child would do that?
Really, someone from New York. Yeah.
Someone from New York. That's how we grew up.
Hard ass child.
A whole bike by like breaking down the metal pieces and stuff.
Oh my god, where'd you see that at?
That's not like in
Discovery Channel.
I think it's Ripley's. Yeah.
Saw it in New York.
That's
funny. Dude eats his bike.
I grew up in New York to eat bicycles.
So yeah, I got my chair.
Uh-huh.
And I figured that I would be able to just go walk over to the post office and get a box.
In the interest of time, tell the first one and then tell how many places you went to and how many trips you took and then tell you where you ended up.
What do you mean?
Say how many places you went to instead of each place.
He tried to help, but
because that would take a while to go through all that.
Well, no, I could quick skim through it, but I ended up going to, I want to say, 4 or 5 different places for a box. And
all cab rides that were fairly expensive.
Each cab ride to and from the hotel to the arena was like 50, 60 bucks. So it was like $60 to $60 back each day. That's three times. If I wanted to go anywhere else,
that's somebody's paycheck that works at McDonald's right there.
That's a whole paycheck.
If I wanted to go somewhere outside of to the arena and back, it's gonna be that same amount depending on where I want to go.
Oh my god!
So I call up the post office, the first post office, and I ask them about. I say I got a folding chair here and I want to ship it. They're like, what are the dimensions? I'm like, it's a folding chair. It's a normal folding chair. I was like, there's nothing special with this folding chair. It's just a normal folding chair. I was like, do you think you have a box that would be big enough to have a folding chair in it? And they're like, we're sorry, we need the dimensions. And I'm just like,
Seamus, I need to mail this cell phone. What can you do to help me?
I need the dimensions.
It's an iPhone. Is there an approved lithium battery in there?
Let me check.
Yeah, they had to weigh it too. They needed the weight.
Oh, they needed the weight.
They needed the weight. They needed the measurements. And I was like,
it's a box.
I was like,
don't you have a scale in a box you can look at?
I was like, I don't have a ruler in the hotel room just laying around. I was like, I can't get you the measurements. It's a normal folding chair.
Can I ballpark it?
I said it's like, you know, maybe 4 or 5 feet high or something like that. And not too wide or whatever. It's just a folding chair.
It's like 3 feet long, you know?
And they're like, you'd have to bring it or whatever, but I don't think we have big enough boxes here or whatever. So I'm like, okay, and I hang up with them. I go back downstairs to the lobby. I tell him, like, okay, we couldn't do it here. He gives me the main post office number. I call them up. Same shit, almost, because they say... I'm trying to think if this was the place where it was like... this was the place where they said that they were all good. Like, they were like, yeah, we could put 2 boxes together. Even if we don't have a box big enough, we can build it for you. We can put 2 boxes together and we can do it.
I like that mentality.
Innovation.
Very good. Very good. Because they were like, yeah, we got...
Intuitive.
Those people are go-getters.
Yeah.
I like that.
She said, she explained it, she's like, we got 15 by like 14 perfect square boxes, but if they don't work, we'll put them together, we'll send it for you and everything like that. I was like, okay, cool, like, I could bring you the chair then? I was like, I don't want to bring the chair and then, you know, end up not being able to do it or whatever.
Yeah.
She's like, well, the problem is we don't have those boxes.
wait, what?
She explained to me that they could put two boxes together of the 14 by 15s. After doing that, they don't have those boxes.
Out of the boxes.
I can see they ran out.
She went through an entire explanation to tell me how I could get this done, only to tell me they didn't have the boxes that could make it happen.
I can see the predicament in that. Actually, you know that when I drive home, there's a space specifically that sells boxes. Maybe I'll give you the number for that.
There's a lot of places that sell boxes.
This is boxes. Boxes, discount boxes. That's a place you need to go.
They needed a box place. What's it called? Costco or something like that. They have boxes just hanging around.
Yeah, they have boxes.
So then I went downstairs and I asked him if there was any kind of UPS or whatever. The guy says, no, there's no UPS near me, which I find out later there is a UPS near me.
There usually is.
But
especially in a city that big, there's got to be a UPS or something.
No, they don't need to make that kind of money in that big city with all the office buildings.
They're just going for the rural areas. Not...
So then I called a FedEx. I called a FedEx this time. He gave me a number for a FedEx. And I called them up.
He was fed up.
They tell me, they got boxes, but their boxes
are not made for them.
I couldn't understand her at first, but like she was saying, you know, it's golf club boxes.
Golf club boxes.
And I'm like,
it's a little too skinny.
Golf club boxes. I'm like, I'm picturing, okay, the really thin, long boxes. And I was like, what the fuck am I going to do with that? What the fuck is that?
We have a saw here to cut the chair in half for you. That would fit
it. Cut it up into pieces. Yeah, just cut it up into pieces.
What am I supposed to do with a golf club box for a folding chair?
You know what?
Every time I called these people, I always opened up that I have a folding chair. Why the fuck would they recommend a golf club box?
We have golf club boxes. So,
I never had this problem, but it's the East Coast against boxes?
I don't know.
I guess they don't have big enough boxes for, like...
They have boxes for boxes, so the boxes can't get there.
Yeah.
So then I remembered that when we got into the hotel, that the place right across from us was like a... It looked like a businessy area.
Okay.
So I said, financial district. I walked right into it. You needed a card to get in. I walked right in. I
need a box for this chair. And I'm coming in.
I walked in.
I'm really upset.
These fucking three ladies walked in after me, and I stopped them, and I was like, you know, excuse me, do you guys work here? Like, I'm in a situation here where I fucking called like three places for a box. I was like, this place looks like it's got some office supplies, printers and shit like that.
Mm-hmm.
Is there a box here for me? Like, can I get a box?
I'll pay you for a box.
They were like, yeah, maybe in the mailroom. And they were saying, like, the mailroom was this way. And then this other guy came up, another guy that worked there.
Uh-huh.
Fucking chicks walked off. The ladies walked off. Then I just started talking to the guy. And I was like, you know, I'm in this situation. I've been trying to get a box all fucking day. And at this point... Like, a few hours have gone by, and I need to get back to the hotel and get this shit situated so that way we can go to Raw.
Mm-hmm.
Because that would be leaving at, like, 5 o'clock or so, and by this time it's, like, 2. And, like, so he says, you know, sure that if I go to the receptionist that he just works at, like, the 10th floor or something like that. And
Jesus,
you know,
Christ.
Yeah.
For this.
So I know it's a pretty big, like, building, so I figured there had to be a box somewhere.
Got to be a box in the building.
So I go inside, and inside they actually they have the receptionist, but she's, like, backed up with a fucking bunch of, like, people in suits because it's a businessy fucking building. Yeah.
So and then, James dresses, you know, someone that's normal, walks up, stands in line behind
with a chair. Probably.
I don't give a shit. No, I didn't have the chair with me. That was the thing.
That would have been.
I wanted to make sure that they were good with the chair before I brought it anywhere. Right. So I went in and I seen the receptionist was all backed up. So then there was a security guy there, like a cop, and I go up to him and I explain everything to him.
Did he laugh at you?
He's just like, he didn't even know like why he was even in today or something like that. He was like, you know, I don't know if they
how does that city even run? Jesus.
Like, it runs some hopes and dreams.
No one has a box. No
everyone
one knows
what to do. Everyone's in the position where they need to be, but no one knows what the fuck to do.
Sounds about right.
Holy shit. He just says to ask the receptionist. So I get in line, I ask the receptionist, and she was pretty nice about it. She actually called. She called the cleaners, and she said that she would ask them if they actually had boxes,
but they didn't fucking pick up. The
they didn't pick
no
up.
No boxes.
They didn't it was pick a up. Day off. Again.
She said she was like, you know, you could wait around until they call me back or whatever. And I was just like, no, I'm not fucking. I don't want to wait here because I gotta go back to the arena pretty soon. So at this point, like, I go back, and I'm just like, man, I went to, like, four fucking places by now. Or I called four places, at least. And I don't know what the fuck to do about a goddamn box. So then I'm like, okay, I finally got to give in, and I got to go to fucking Home Depot. $60 trip to Home Depot. I go to Home Depot. Damn.
Please tell me they had a box.
They have boxes, but they got the same boxes that we use to move, like, yeah, our stuff.
It's
which
ginormous.
Like, so they're, like, really big.
They're pretty wide, not tall enough.
But so, you know what? I'm you should like, go to that old lady and she'd be like, hey, I got you the box. Make it happen.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. Go to FedEx and be like, here, put these two to fucking together or something like that.
You can do it.
So I was like, I went around Home Depot and I asked somebody, like, I was like, you know, can somebody, like, I need to find a box that fits a folding chair. And
did they
shit
know
you
what
not,
a folding chair is?
Right next to the boxes were folding chairs. And I was it's right fucking there. It's that same folding chair. Just picture that folding chair in this box.
Can't do it.
Does it work?
We need the dimensions for that chair.
Can you bring those for me off the bar? You're telling me this right now with a straight face. I don't believe those chairs were there.
They were there.
I can't believe it.
There were white folding chairs right next to the boxes. And I was like, just picture that chair. If that chair would work in this box, it would work. And like she was saying that those boxes there, that's the biggest they come. Mm-hmm. And then she pointed out that they have these makeshift boxes, these ones where they're kind of folded at all different angles, all different points, and you basically fold it on your own to form.
You make your
build
shape.
A box.
You make your own box. You
build
they
a box.
They have Build-A-Bear.
Yeah.
Build a box.
Or your chair.
I didn't even get a goddamn Build-A-Bear in Boston. I wanted a Build-A-Bear in Boston. But, so I was like, she started saying, you know, that I would have to get, you know, box cutter, stuff like that. And I'm just like, oh my God, it took me $60 to get here and I gotta buy more shit just to get this box done. I was like, I was talking to my cousin, I was like, I really don't want to have like a home crafting thing in the hotel going on, like while I'm trying to do this. So then,
DIY.
She says, you know, that there's a UPS nearby. Oh, there's a UPS nearby.
Oh my God.
She says to go up to the receptionist or the what is it called?
Customer service
at Home Depot and ask them for the UPS
number. By the way, just so you know, halfway this, I would have just shot myself.
Yeah.
Fuck the chair.
Throw it
in the river.
Someone else can deal with the chair.
Throw it a crowd.
I go up to get the UPS number from the lady, and she spends a good 5 minutes because she can't find the number.
Oh, God forbid.
There's no number for this UPS. She gives me the in general UPS number. It turns out that specific UPS center does not have a number. Like, you have
to... Wait, technology?
Unlisted. Unlisted.
Yeah. Oh, you have to go...
Off the grid.
I guess you have to go through the main hub of UPS or whatever. So I called them up, and they were like... I asked them, I was like, can you patch me in to this local one so that way I could see if they have boxes. Mm-hmm. And she was like, see, that UPS actually doesn't have a number that you call us. Pretty much like the hub, you have to call them, you have to talk to them.
How is that, by the way, UPS?
How's that efficient?
They don't want
by the way,
you know,
I need
business,
to talk to
so.
UPS out there. I know you're listening, UPS, because you love Creature Talk. So I just want to say,
again,
I don't know why each center doesn't have a number.
How does this city work?
Yeah,
unlisted UPS stores, no boxes.
Actually, you forgot to pick up the can with the string, and this is where you're like,
Oh my god.
Hello, UPS.
Yeah, UPS, local UPS, help me.
It's like Morse code.
But the lady on the phone, she assured me that, like, I would be able to do this at
the
UPS.
Assured.
She was 100% cool.
Guaranteed.
She was like, you know, we could do this, we could weigh it.
We can build it.
We could build a box just like that. We could build a box.
Can make it stronger.
Not this again. You're messing with my emotions.
And now, the thing is...
You gotta get to the store.
We need the chair with us. I need the chair that they could fit the box over. I was like, could you just make a big enough box? I said, I will buy your biggest box.
Your finest box.
To make sure.
Give me the box coated with gold.
The finest box you have.
The best box you got in stock. I will fucking buy it. No matter the price, I'll buy it so it fits the fucking chair. And she was just like, we need to have the item here.
Or the dimensions.
Fuck!
Or the dimensions.
I was just like, okay. okay, so wait. I gotta pay $60 to go back to the hotel, get the chair. $60 to go back out here to get to the UPS to get this done. And then that doesn't even count the cost of shipping it. And I was just like, no fucking way.
This is the best thing
ever. I went back to the aisles. I got that fucking makeshift box. I got the box cutters. I got the fucking tape. And I took all that shit back to the hotel. And you, that's where I sat there for hours
and you crafted that box.
I heard after that moment, James DM me. He's like, you know what? I'm going to make a DIY channel. Do it yourself.
Do it yourself box.
This is how it is. 10 million views on that.
Jesus, I couldn't believe it.
I would, if you make
so
that
there's the box story.
DIY
that one
channel.
Tweet he made when that was happening did not describe what
nothing.
He was
going no, nothing. That was everything that I had to go through to get that
it's
box
like the
together
adventure
to send
of the box
just
continues.
So you know, if you make a video teaching me how to craft the box to put a folding chair, I will watch it, like it, and favor it.
Who would have thought that in a city of millions of people it'd be that hard to find a
it
box?
It sounds so janky, they don't have a phone number.
Yeah.
All right.
We don't want business there, so.
Well, I don't have money, so.
Oh, sounds like a plan.
Sounds like we can work together.
Yeah, we can work this out.
You know what? Just for those stories, that was worth it.
That was just for the fucking box.
James's expense of all that cab.
I didn't go
box
through it. I didn't go through it. I didn't feel the pain.
All for that chair that sits right over there against the wall.
And the box that sits over there. I even took the time to wrote fragile on it.
Where is it? Oh, it was nasty.
That's it.
I'm gonna bring that.
I'm gonna take
a picture of that for the Creech Talk background.
You could probably sign that box and sell it.
People are
gonna be
watching Creech Talk like, why is there a picture of this nasty fragile box?
Ew.
It was longer than that. I had to cut around it. Like I had to cut with
a bad one right here.
Did you use the entire roll of
did
tape
you have,
on
did
that?
Did you have enough?
I made sure. The thing was, I didn't want to leave any tape with them at the hotel, so I made sure that I wanted to use all of it.
You used the entire roll.
You were scared that.
No, I was already leaving them a free box cutter. For the next book, and I left the other box. It came with an inner box and an outer box, and I left the outer box for the next poor soul that fucking needs
way,
a box.
By the way, you bought the extra strength box.
I didn't even know that was extra strength.
Yeah.
That is a fine box.
By the way,
extra resistant enough.
See how I cut the top of it like that?
Cajas.
Hey, that's Spanish. Shut up. You can't believe that. Es resistentes de las cajas. That's how you say it.
It's a very
this
good
box.
Box.
We'll go down in history.
It made it. It made
box.
It here.
That
it
is a historic
here.
Box.
Fisher's like, oh.
Good girl. Good box. I'm going to put this box away.
That is a very historic box.
Box
So yeah, that was the box.
My
box
God!
Story. And then finally, I mean, it was like maybe 3 or 4 o'clock, and we finally departed for Monday Night Raw. Which was by far the most nutty fucking event I've ever.
So you'd say was that worth the trip?
That made the trip. It was way better. It was way better. It was pretty much. It was like a Philly crowd. It was a fucking.
Oh
Philly
no!
Yeah, no, those are good.
It was. They were. They had Orton versus Sheamus in a match. Where they headlocked at least 3 times and the crowd could not give a bigger shit. They fucking booed as much as you can boo. Like, they booed them both.
Or doing
but,
headlocks.
Like, they just kept doing headlocks and, like, slow moves and stuff like that, and it was just a boring match. So the crowd entertained themselves. We started doing the wave.
I heard.
We started chanting for the ice cream guy. The
ice cream
guy. The fucking ice cream guy was into it. When they started chanting, ice cream guy, ice cream guy, the ice cream guy was like, yeah! You just seen him in the corner.
He was
like,
drinking.
This is my life!
This is why.
You got ice cream? Who wants it?
This is why I sell
it's free
ice cream.
Now. It's free.
And then the pretzel guy had like a little, like a pretzel, like on a stick or whatever, just like as a symbol or whatever, and he was just like holding it up.
Pretzel guy.
You know, you and that whole crowd made those Tuesdays. Like,
probably their year.
Made their
right
life.
There.
Yeah.
Shit.
In a wrestling event and Day with the Stars.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Having like, 11,000 people chanting at you at the
ice
same
cream
time.
Guy.
So then they were chanting. That I don't think that chant made it on air, but they had a chant for X-Pac was there. Like, he was the 1-2-3 kid.
Yeah, he's
old.
The 1-2-3 kid.
He was like in one of the boxes at the top and like. I guess they seen him there and they were chanting for him. They chanted like RVD. They chanted ECW.
Really?
They chanted Randy Savage. They chanted HBK. They chanted,
what the fuck is wrong with the whole...
They chanted for anyone but the people in the ring. Like, they chanted for,
For Pikachu?
They chanted
for... For Agumon? For Carter?
Pokemon, yeah.
Really?
No, they're grown-ups.
I'm sorry.
Philly crowd. You think a Philly crowd would chant for fucking...
No, that was just giving
it's like them. Adventure time! Adventure time!
I would do it! Right there. Me on that.
They were chanting for Justin Roberts, which is the announcer, the ring announcer. They chanted for Michael Cole. They chanted for Jerry the King Lawler. They chanted for JBL. All the people at the announcer's booth. They chanted for the fucking referee.
Really? I would have chanted for the ref.
For the camera guy, which is, his name was Disco Stew or something
Disco
like that.
Stew.
Disco Stew. Chanted Disco Stew. And like he was doing a little dance like when they were chanting for him.
Disco Stew. Big shout out to you guys from the Creatures.
Then finally Big Show came out and interrupted the match, and then a big thank you, Big Show champ broke out. Then he started throwing chairs. He was throwing the announcers' chairs, and like people were chanting one more chair because he was throwing chairs around, and then he started getting booed because he didn't throw one more chair. But that was the only reason he got booed. There was "We Want Ziggler" chants throughout the entire night for him to cash in. Like he has like a briefcase that lets him get a title shot at any moment.
He's been hanging on that for a while.
So like they were just chanting "We Want Ziggler" the entire night, and he finally cashed it in like randomly at one of the moments, and everyone just fucking blew up. Like it was fucking ridiculous.
I don't know much of him. I'm sorry.
It was just like he's a good like. Amateur wrestler. He started doing like amateur wrestling and stuff like that. He's a really like he's a good wrestler, but he never really had a shot like the big time, I guess.
Oh.
Like he had that ticket to get to the big time with the briefcase, but he never cashed it in until Monday.
Oh, that's
so cool. That like he got a really big pop for that. And then the main thing was fucking Fandango coming out.
Oh no.
And he's a really new guy that they probably introduced.
Yeah, I never heard of him.
He was probably introduced like maybe 3 weeks ago or so.
What is he? That sounds saucy.
He's got a disco kind of gimmick going on.
Really?
He says his name.
Disco?
Somewhat, like Disco Inferno?
It's like a Latin dance atmosphere.
Most of those are floppy. Like they don't really make it out.
No, at the beginning when he first debuted, people were chanting, "You can't wrestle" to him and stuff.
Really?
But here, like when he came out, people were chanting his theme. Like, they were singing his theme. Like, everyone in the arena was... It was just like... I can't really play it. I don't know. I wish I could play it.
Is it, like, salsa?
Does this work?
No, it's on or not.
Is it salsa? Or what is it? Because I'm assuming Fandango.
It just goes like... It's just like a little, it's a catchy tune like that, and the whole crowd was doing it, and they were just like going all dancing and stuff, and that they panned out, and all you see is like a bunch of the crowd. Like nobody gives a shit. Everybody's just fucking chanting his song.
They were trying to make a good time for like the shitty thing that was going on.
So yeah. But like it was funny because at the end, this is dead. What the fuck?
Yeah.
Show me the song. What is it? I'll try to find it.
But they had. Like Cena was knocked out at the end by Ryback, and then he came on the mic like afterwards after they went off air, and he just got up and he was just like, "His theme song, really? Like you guys are chanting his theme song?" And they kept going, like they were fucking singing his song still. And then like he said, usually at the end of an event they would play a song to kind of like have, you know, when people were leaving they'd play a song like someone's theme song or something like that. But he said like this time, you know, you guys could be the song. Like, you guys can just sing your own way out. And, like, so everyone starts doing it or whatever, and then they finally play his theme, and that gets everyone into it. And, like,
I think I have it.
Everyone fucking through the corridors, going out of the arena, out in the parking lot, using their car horns. They were fucking doing his theme song.
Go for it.
You just play the first few seconds of it.
Here goes. Here's the Fandango song. Let's see if I got it right.
Did you spell it right? Or should it be something random?
Tell me if I got it right.
Yeah, there you go.
Alright, here it goes.
Dude.
Pretty catchy when everyone's doing it like that. So the entire crowd was doing that all the way out to the car and shit, and it was pretty fucking ridiculous. There's a video of them on the subway doing it, like going home on the subway train doing it.
Wow!
Like it fucking caught on pretty damn quick.
That probably is gonna make him.
That dude's career has been made because of that one night, just them chanting that.
That's all you need as a wrestler. That's like that one thing, and
yeah.
Then, What does that do that used to say yes and now saying no?
That was last year. That was Daniel Bryan, and he still does it. Like, he took that through the entire year. But that started the night after WrestleMania last year. It's like there's always something the night after, WrestleMania that somebody gets made. Pretty much. Awesome. Someone gets made.
Isn't he, like, now tag team with Kane?
Yeah, yeah. Right. But someone gets made, like, after that, because the crowd is fucking bonkers after that.
Well, that was cool. At least it was worth it, then.
That role was worth it. It was pretty good to, like, have such a nutty-ass crowd and shit. But the people, there were people in the row. There was a guy in the row in front of me that was pissed off. It was a guy that, he was dressed up like CM Punk. But when people were chanting, "We want Ziggler," throughout the entire night, like, he looked back and he was like, "Stop being pussies. He still has 4 months left," or whatever. And then he cashed in on that night. And I just said really loud, I was like, "Man, this guy must feel really fucking stupid right now that he just cashed in and he had 4 months left." Then there were these Cena fans that were, like, off to the side, and they were getting pissed off, I guess, because of all the hate for Cena. And it's like, Jesus, we just give us one fucking night to have this. It's like they came expecting, I guess, you know, a solid Cena fan.
Cena praise.
Yeah. And he was getting booed and stuff. And at randomly at one point during the show, like, they just stood up and they didn't sit down. And, like, people were telling them behind to sit the fuck down. And they looked back and they were like, in all, like, you know, being an asshole in their asshole-ish manner. They were they were just like, "Oh, we're ruining the show for you guys." And I was just like,
oh, God.
I was like, "Why the fuck you gotta be a dickhead for?" Like it's not just this section that's chanting. It's the entire fucking arena that's chanting. And, like, this shit blew up on them. She was like, "Sit the fuck down before I beat the shit out of you." And she was wearing a Cena shirt. And she was Hispanic, too, so I knew that she was gonna go down. They didn't sit the fuck down.
If they did not, she would have probably...
I was just sitting there like... I'll wait for it to happen, because I would just top off the night there. She started fighting him.
She would have hit him hard.
She would have, man.
Latina chicks are having a bad
Rock's
temper.
Mom?
Oh, yeah, there was this guy at WrestleMania that went ape shit about getting a picture of The Rock's mom. Yeah. Like, she was sitting there in the front row or whatever, where the family sits or whatever, and he was coming through to, go up and get something to drink or something like that. Every person that he walked past going through the row, he'd show a picture. "Look at the picture of The Rock's mom! Look! It's The Rock's mom!" And it's like, you know, whoa! Holy shit!
If you were to take a picture, was he a Punk's mom?
Oh, I don't even know what she looks like.
Exactly. Think about it. You're like, "Whoa, I met her, and now I took a picture."
Oh, now it's over.
It's done.
I should have took a picture with, like, Jim's mom and dad.
Whoa!
Jim's mom and dad.
Happy wheels! Whoa, mom!
Shit.
They were the seed. They put the seed in Jim.
Wow.
Man.
Without them, Jim wouldn't be possible. Without Jim, Happy Wheels, it's just a string.
It's a chain. It's a chain, man, you know?
I need to find his ancestors.
Jim's ancestors.
I made a family tree for you.
Yeah, that would be creepy.
Can you saw my family tree?
Of your family?
On this coconut?
Yeah. Jesus.
Well, that was wrestling.
But yeah, that was about pretty much the entire trip. Holy shit. All the fucking ridiculous shit I had to go through during that.
I like it.
Crazy antics.
So what is next on the list? That was pretty legit. You actually kept
going. That was
pretty fucking legit.
I listened to that pretty much whole thing the other day, so I was just kind of sitting here like,
I'm sorry that you were not feeding him more energy. I was interested in the story.
Doesn't stop me midway while I'm telling him all this stuff, but instead he's just like, "Why didn't we save this for Creature Talk?"
Sly and I went to a show.
Yeah.
We don't care about that.
It's Bad Religion.
It was Bad Religion, and I am a fan. Oh, I don't have the shirt. I had it.
A fucking shirt of a shark.
Where? No, I thought.
Fan of sharks.
Was that like the Pepsi Center or something?
No, it was Fillmore. Fillmore Auditorium.
This was actually the first time that I ever seen Bad Religion. I know of them. I haven't really heard much of them. Like, he's more of a fan of them. But I just know that, I'm like, he's like, "Let's go watch Bad Religion." I'm like, "Tony Hawk, yes."
Yep. It wasn't that far away from the NWO thing, like the fake Coliseum stuff. It was like right up the street. It was like maybe a mile away from that.
Yeah.
It's called You.
Is it?
Yeah, it's called You.
How is it called then?
I'm not a singer. I don't sing.
There's a place.
Why don't you just pull it up on your phone? You pull up the Fandango song.
There's a few songs that I know, like, from Tony Hawk, but I don't fucking know this song.
It's from Tony Hawk.
It goes like
this. Yeah, that's what it sounds like.
You know that song?
It sounds like you're doing the Chocobo thing. The Chocobo from fucking Asgard is what you're doing. You sound like right now.
Oh, man.
I'll find. This is the song that I knew that I was going to be like.
It's called You.
Yeah, I have it here right now.
You.
So meanwhile, you could talk about.
Okay, so a few, probably about a week ago, this happened. Yeah, most people know that Disney acquired, Lucas. Pretty much everything Lucas for a lot of money.
So they acquired it just to can it.
They acquired Lucas Arts Entertainment like studios with it, which is what makes all the games, which is famous for making Battlefront, Knights of the Republic, and like Jedi Academy and stuff like that. And recently they made kind of a few poop games, but they had a few good games in the. They had Star Wars First Assault, which is going to be kind of like, it would be kind of like Battlefront 3, and then there's also. Star Wars 1313, which was, the next-gen title. Disney decided to can LucasArts.
Smart
shut
move.
Down everything.
Smart move.
Cancel every single game they had in development.
Fucking smart. Smart. Good move on them.
Just, they've turned into now a licensing so that they could make those games still, but whoever picks them up has to start them from complete scratch.
Smart.
Why did they pick them up then? Why would they pick them up then?
I don't know, because they would have had at least a little bit of free advertising. That's about all I can think of, because it's like they completely canned everything, shut down every single bit.
What were they working on, though? I mean, they weren't working
on too much. It was 1313 and First Assault, and then possibly, I don't know about like looking into like Battlefront 3 and stuff like that, but...
Jesus.
They completely... Gone! Mickey Mouse destroyed everything!
How long can they continue to, like, reproduce Star Wars games with, like, an original spin?
Forever.
Like, that hasn't been done before.
Probably a good amount of times.
Forever.
Like, the Star Wars universe, it has a lot of possibilities, though they haven't worked off of them.
The Force Unleashed 3. 2014.
That game's coming. That game sucked.
Yeah.
They have potential of such a massive universe, but they have not yet taken full advantage of it.
Their fault. What the fuck?
I know, but it's still potential that they could have had, and they completely
squandered potential.
Deep Silver will get it.
Yeah, I mean, if they want to get a Star Wars game, I'd be all for that because that'd be awesome. But
Star Wars Zombies.
So yeah, it was really sad. I'm never going back to a Disney park again.
Yeah, you are.
Yeah, probably.
Meanwhile, come July, we're going to Florida.
Just a little side note before we wrap that up.
He's got the song.
I saw a picture, and this picture was funny.
Hold on, I want to see what the song is and see if I recognize it.
Tony Hawk Pro Skater 2, I think.
Yeah.
I don't know. I kind of recognize it.
Yeah, it's
been so long since I played it, I can't remember.
Yeah, it's a really iconic. It was a really good show. But anyways, where were you guys going at?
I was gonna say one last thing. Someone put a picture up. I don't know where it was, but it was on one of those internet pictures from
meme
the internet.
Pictures?
Yeah,
pictures.
Those internet
the
pictures.
Internet pictures? Holy
anyway,
shit!
Anyway,
fuck that.
It was
when
three.
Was that?
It was
that
like
nothing?
A comic of the part where Anakin goes and kills the little Jedi's.
Uh huh.
I didn't know about that. What?
I did not
he
know
kills
that?
The Jedi's, the little tiny kids.
I didn't know about that.
Yeah, he slaughters them.
Spoiling.
Why'd he do that?
They Photoshop Mickey's face over Anakin and all the game titles over all the kids.
Smart.
It was perfect. And it explains exactly, what's going on. And they're like, what are we going to do, Master Mickey? And he just sits there. Hoo-hoo! Oh, boy!
Destroys
everything. Die, LucasArts!
That's awesome.
Disappointing.
They're gone.
There comes a time where...
You gotta let go.
Yeah, the new age is coming in,
Let go of the past.
The new age.
The new age.
You gotta either... You either are part of the new things, or you're not.
You get left behind. Philosophy. Keep up or get left
Let's
behind.
Let's license a Star Wars game and make one in the Unreal Engine.
Yeah, you gonna buy that?
Yeah.
Let's do it.
Yeah, okay.
Let's do it.
Let's take out the biggest loan.
If we take an original character, we make it a third-person action game where we have physics going all over the place. You can throw shit and do all that. You can make him evil.
Let me see what we got.
Facial animations.
Yeah,
really good. Next thing, this one I won't
go into
too much.
Let me see the fucking list, you asshole.
Unreal Engine 4 released at GDC tech demo called the Infiltrator tech demo.
We could have went to that. GDC?
Yeah,
right away at the PAX? Really?
I'm just saying that I found out that we actually
We
could have gotten into that.
We should look into that next year, because that is where Valve makes themselves pretty prominent.
I mean, right after PAX. You fucking have the stamina built up, and you can do it.
I know.
Don't bitch about it.
I won't.
You're gonna fucking
You're not
do
coming.
It.
I'm not just because of that complaint.
You
right
go straight.
There. It'll
straight
be me
from,
and James and whoever else.
Straight
feels
from
like,
Boston
like
to
if
that.
Seamus.
Maybe if I get my pass for that in time, on like a day after the convention starts,
oh, yeah.
I'm packed.
Oh,
yeah. That's pretty shitty.
Yeah, they mail it to you. Oh,
I got
yeah,
it Friday. Go. Pack started Thursday.
Push it.
Like but yeah, the UA4 Infiltrator demo showed off just kind of another cinematic in the engine, and
did
it's
look good.
Looking really good. It's, you know, just a good engine.
I'm excited for that.
It's going to fuel probably most of the next-gen titles.
Great.
You just make sure to learn how
pop-ins
to
pop-ins like crazy for all the next-gen titles.
It's not
going to
have
can't
pop-ins.
Wait.
It's not going to have pop-ins.
How do you know?
It's not going to have pop-ins, man.
How do you
how
know?
Do you know?
Mary
know.
Pop-ins?
By the way, just a question from a person that doesn't actually know anything. What the fuck is a pop-in?
A texture pop-in.
Texture
like
pop-in.
When it looks all muddy
like
and stuff.
Low res, and then all of a sudden it
like
refreshes.
Or whatever.
Gears.
Rage?
Yeah, Rage.
Oh, you heard Rage?
Rage was
that
really
wasn't
bad.
I don't think that was Unreal, was it?
It had terrible texture pop-ins. I don't know if it was Unreal.
I can't
though.
Remember if it was or not. It might have been, but
texture pack.
It usually if yeah. a developer is I said this last time, like developers that don't know what they're doing with it don't know how to master it, which is kind of funny because Gears and like every Epic game has it. They created the engine, but they still can't figure out how to get rid of it. But like people like BioWare got rid of it for Mass Effect, so there's no texture pop-ins.
What, the third one?
Second and third one. There's no texture pop-ins.
Really?
Yeah.
First one has them.
First one does have them, yeah.
You're stuck on first that. You're stuck on that.
First one has them. Their trilogy, they got to do a remastered version of the first one now.
They got to redo it.
Star Wars does that.
They may have fixed it when they did the redux for like for PS3. They may have fixed it.
Yeah.
So, maybe I don't know. I've never really...
Yeah, and they overcharged the hell. It was like $60, and you could get them for like $10 each, except for the third one.
Huh? Yeah, that's not surprising.
They didn't even release
yeah,
it.
Yeah, UA4 Tech Demo.
EA... Sports.
It's in the game.
We have your money.
They have
your money.
We have your money. So
it looks cool though. I can't wait till. I think they had given like a rough release. It's available. Like I'm almost considering trying to license the engine because it would be available to me instantly.
What are you talking about?
Unreal Engine 4?
Doesn't that cost a lot of money?
It's not a whole lot. Like it depends on the license you get. Because I was looking into it. So.
The fuck are you going to do with it?
Yeah.
Jerk off and look at
it. I'm going to learn it early.
Yeah, but what the fuck are you going to do with it?
Make movies of Pie Jacks pooping.
More
defined
now.
Particle systems.
No texture poppets on the poop.
No texture poppets.
There's going to be the most complex liquid particle system you've ever seen spewing from
diarrhea
his tiny...
Diarrhea at its finest.
And no texture poppins. The
volumetric better. Lighting on that.
So it'll like leak over and
oh, it'll
like,
leak and
yeah.
drizzle.
Actually, you'll feel the poop coming to your keyboard. Like, ah, fuck. God damn it, I'm watching a James video.
That's 5D. That's the fifth dimension right there.
And he's
actual liquid
it.
Coming out of the keyboard.
He's breaking
them. You'll get the smell. You'll get the visuals, the smell. You
can
fucking
you
know, all the
it.
Dimensions. Go, it'll
scratch
terrible.
And sniff on your screen.
Yeah, it'll be amazing.
Ew.
Okay. Battle
like
Block.
Ass.
Battle Block.
I regret it.
Oh, Battle Block.
Battle Block
Theater.
Battle Block.
Amazing
theater.
Game.
By who?
Behemoth.
Behemoth?
Yes.
They
made Castle Crashers.
Yep.
Alien.
Alien Hominid, which was probably one of the most impossible games of all time.
Yep.
Yeah.
I haven't really played that much. I haven't
so what is
really,
it? Talk to me. What the hell is going on? I never played it. I've seen. I know. For the most that I know, and this is which we talked about it before, is that. Anytime that you and Alex are playing, Alex is really upset. That's all I know. I just hear that I'm either playing smart, just hanging out, or recording myself, and I just hear, Jace! Jace! Please help me!
It's a,
what is it?
It's a,
the
it's a,
it?
The campaign is all kinds of wacky, where it's just like, okay, you're on a ship or whatever,
and
you get like
cool.
you get shipwrecked or whatever, and it's a prison full of cats. Cats, the cat
security cats.
The security cats have taken over everything, and so they're making you. Essentially, they're making you perform, I guess, on a stage. Yeah, the levels are supposed to be like as if you're performing on a stage, and
for the kitties.
Yeah, for the cats. It's a crowd full of cats, and
this game was built for a Kucha.
Yeah.
Why are you playing it? Let Kucha play this game. Jesus.
He can fucking play it if he wants.
Kucha
yeah,
play the goddamn
me.
Game.
Yeah,
what
me.
That? What a
damn. I'm
gonna
play
the
Z.
So it's you go through it's kind of like a platformer type deal
platformer.
Where it's each level is kind
is
of based
on platformer than Castle Crashers because Castle
yes.
Crashers is
kinda
more
like bloody,
kinda
like
yeah
Crash
they're
Land?
Done they're done with that they said after Castle Crashers that they like they've done what they can with that genre so they're done with
so
that
so you
like
tell me like it's platform like more like Bloody Trap Land whatever it's called bloody
yes kind of yeah
cool.
yeah like what yeah yeah
So it's kind of like that, in that it has like its ragey moments, I guess, where it's like, if you're playing co-op, the levels are like, you have to cooperate pretty much, because there's specific actions that you do to like that you can shortcut, I guess. They are time based. You're not really judged much on time. You go through the level.
Time based, but you're not judged in time.
It's an extra perk that you would get. Like, if you were to collect everything in the level and beat it in the best amount of time, you'll get like 2 extra gems. The gems are what you collect gems throughout the entire mission. You need to collect 3 gems. There's like maybe 6 or 7, sometimes 5, sometimes less, like on the level. But you have to get 3 of them to unlock the exit. So you're thrown in. You have to find at least 3 gems to unlock the exit to get out of the level, to beat the level. Then they have, you know, more gems that you can get throughout the level if you want to find them all. Then they have a yarn ball that you can get, that if you collect 5 yarn balls, you'll get a weapon. Kitties. A weapon from the kitties. Yeah, they'll give you a weapon. You have to pay them in yarn balls. And so, you know, like, the gems are used to get different faces, like heads.
Yeah, outfits.
For your character or whatever. And they have a shit ton of different combinations. So you're constantly going to the shop to buy weapons and then to buy heads.
What do you need the weapons for?
The weapons do, like, different shit. Like, they're all different. Like, there's a, like, a golf ball thing. There's, like, a fucking paper airplane that explodes. There's a Nerf gun. And the Nerf gun's really cool. We were saying that the Nerf gun's probably the most OP thing in the game. Because it's a... you can use the Nerf gun to knock enemies over. Like, you shoot at them and you can knock them over and stuff like that. But on top of that, if you hit the Nerf gun, the sticky, like, dart on the side of a wall, it'll stick to the wall. And you can use it as a platform.
Oh,
and
that's cool.
So, that's pretty good. There's a fucking frog that I was using to kill Alex a lot. It's a frog that goes... It'll keep going until it kills somebody, pretty much. It'll go up through the map and go wherever the fuck it needs to go until it finds somebody to blow up. And,
that's awesome.
Yeah, so the frogs are pretty cool. There's a bunch of different weapons that you use throughout the entire thing. There's, like, a grenade. There's, what the fuck else is there? There's like fireballs. There's an electric ball, stuff like that. It's a bunch of random shit that they got in there. Throughout the level, there are cats in the level that you can fight. Like they try
to fuck you up and kill you and stuff like that. Alex was showing me something. Have you guys uploaded the first recording session already?
Yeah.
What was it where you threw him or something against 3 really tough enemies?
Oh, like 4 of them? There was like yeah, 4
and
cats
he just
lined
went
up.
Super Saiyan.
There were like gifs of it where he was fighting like 4 cats at once, and I was just standing there watching him fight.
Laughing your ass off, like a dick. And he kills all of them, and then when he dies at the end.
Yeah, there's a button to commit suicide, because if there are cases where you could get stuck in the level and you could screw yourself over.
That's cool, they give you that.
So, like, you could kill yourself to go back to like a checkpoint or something like that within the level. There's, the B button is like your power or whatever, and then they have like that you can throw your partner over to like a place where you can't reach it normally and stuff like that.
And that's where like he can go into corner and give you the handstand.
But it's cool because it has like the game has a level builder, so it has like infinite fucking possibilities where it's like
you can have the fans just troll you.
Yeah,
it's like it sounds like another.
You can
like,
make really fucking hard levels, and the behemoth will actually they go through. The thing is for user made levels, they change gems and yarn to like. I forget what it is, like cakes or something like that, and cherries or something like that.
Why?
They don't give you gems.
Oh,
like, you can't earn gems, and you can't earn stuff that you
because it'll be
cheap.
Like, somebody can just make it, like, a whole, just walk in the street line
with
20.
You can't do that. So the behemoth will go through some of the playlists, and they'll actually feature some. And when they feature them,
then they
change to gems and yarn. So you actually can order, like, it you just have to go through like the behemoth feature.
So it seems like a possibility, like kind of Happy Wheels, like the more the better
if the levels are good quality and behemoth actually actively goes through and finds good ones to feature,
it's
you can keep playing it like afterwards. And they have like that if you complete a certain playlist of their featured ones, you'll unlock a special head that you can only get through that. Like they have the chicken logo.
Oh
right
yeah
now. Their chicken head logo.
Chicken.
Huh. That's legit.
That big chicken.
So fun factor of 1 to 5 Whoopi Goldbergs. 5 being the best. Fun factor.
It's really fun. It's five.
You give it 5?
Yeah, it's really fun. Huh, like that. I don't know. I'm having more fun with that than a lot of my other playthroughs that I've been doing. Like that game is really, really fun. Like I was looking forward to it for a while, and then I got into the closed beta, and the levels were different in the closed beta, I think. but like you know, it wasn't finished yet.
So is it better than War C?
Yeah. No, it's not.
No, War Z.
You are crazy.
War Z.
That was a test and you failed.
War Z.
War Z is the best game.
War Z gave me 2 free katanas.
Whoa.
I haven't used them yet.
Seamus dished out some for a katana.
I did.
I don't know why they gave them to me. Like, I tried to buy a flashlight.
They're trying to appease you. They're like, yeah. Oh,
also, by the way, just a quick question for both. I think, yeah, just for Seamus mainly, but what is this tweet that I saw you saying that Comcast upped your internet speed because apparently Google is about to start coming our way? Or what happened?
They're starting to expand a little. They started off in like Kansas City and they expanded around that area, but then they announced like a week or two ago that they were going to Austin. So like a bunch of people just got random speed upgrades. Yeah. Like
I don't have it.
Well, they
doubling the speed.
Yeah, they emailed me and they said like, oh, you've been upgraded to like 105 download and 20 upload, but like I don't have the speeds. Like I don't know if it's my modem, like it just can't support it, or
they,
if I just
sometimes
have to,
they have to put like a
Google Fiber.
Someone actually came for what is it, CenturyLink? Someone came. I put the shit there.
Number.
He came and said that they had installed fiber optic in the area.
What?
Yeah.
Oh, did they?
What?
Yeah.
Wow.
Fiber.
That's what he
CenturyLink?
Said.
CenturyLink fiber optic?
That's what he said.
That's just saying, by the
They're
way.
They're scared about
to
it.
To anybody out there that has the ability to have Google Internet, drop whatever company you have. I don't care if your dad works there. Drop it.
Like, if people are confused, like, for internet that I had, like, the Extreme 50 was probably, like, $100-something, which is, like, a 50 download and a 10 upload. Yeah. But, like, Google Fiber is just kind of testing markets, and they're running like 1,000 download, 1,000 upload with no bandwidth cap for $70 a month. You have to pay like $300 or $500 bucks to get
the $70 a month. You don't have to pay the $300.
Oh, really?
Yeah, when you do the free internet, you have to do the $300.
Oh, okay.
Because you can get free, like it's like 30-10.
That
is
internet speed,
but you have to pay the $300 install.
Like, what other place outside the states? Like, what is it?
30-10
is it Korea? What is it? North Korea that has it?
It's like South Korea has incredible internet.
Maybe we'll start getting that internet.
Sweden,
you know?
Already
and
has
maybe
that.
Fucking my asshole expensive. Will never stop.
Well, the problem
ain't gonna fucking matter what speed we got if we keep getting taken down. It ain't gonna matter.
Yeah.
I'm just saying though.
Problem with North America is that they kind of run an oligopoly.
Did he say anything about speeds? Yeah. Or did he just say fiber optics?
He's a fiber op.
No. You'd probably assume that's probably gonna be pretty fast.
So what's next on the list?
Battlefield 4. This was another GDC thing.
Oh my god.
They released a 17-minute.
You seen the trailer?
Yeah,
no.
Yeah, I seen
minutes.
That.
I saw a bunch
seen
of people upload it.
17-minute trailer about 5 different times.
I seen
different
it.
People talking.
By the
about
way,
it.
just a quick thing. Me and Alex were making mad fun of it, but there are certain people that have been uploading this fucking trailer and giving their opinion on them. These people have never or like don't rarely ever play Battlefield, and they're like, I'm gonna quote one specific one. I don't know who it was because I don't need to say, but he was like, oh my god, in this cutscene, the floor breaks and you can slide down the fucking floor only on Battlefield.
You do that in Call of Duty on zombies.
Yeah, I know! That's what I'm saying! Like, I'm like,
it goes super fast.
Yeah,
it shoots it out there.
I'm like, no, he's like, and this thing comes down to you, and the floor breaks, and you go down, and you're like, oh my god, this is crazy. Man. Only in Battlefield 4. I'm like, last time I checked, that happened before.
I would have did that entire video and like pumped it up and been like, man, this game looking so good and stuff, and at the very end I'd just like, you know, go away and be like, is it still browser based? It's like, yeah.
Damn.
I retract everything I said about this.
Even Alex made a video making fun of it. It's just like, some people, if you're gonna make an analysis of the trailer, at least like put some homework, like, and just try to.
No,
do
it
some,
just felt
do
like
some
it was
research.
More of like a scripted thing where they
yeah,
like.
Yeah, a lot of people scripted it.
Throw a script
like,
in
oh
front of
God.
Them or something like that.
Plug our game. Here's a script. Watch the trailer.
But how do you go about? How do you go about from like EA's standpoint, and they're trying to market for the rival company? How do you go about like telling them, be like, you know, you gotta say something it's good, like, but don't compare it to Call of Duty. You
that's
gotta
a, that's
like.
That's not really a comparison, I do all the time.
When can you tell me? Like, the only thing they've made comparing to Call of Duty recently is like the.
Because they probably don't want that. They
the
probably CQB don't want that.
The CQB update where they put like smaller maps and like faster paced gameplay. All other Battlefield like gameplay.
Humongous.
Bad Company 2, you know, Battlefield 3. Massive maps.
That's what they're
more players.
For. A lot of
it's
like
it's
that.
A completely different style. I don't see. They don't need to compete with.
Because
them.
They both have guns and it's both first person.
Yeah,
so
that's
like when people are saying, oh, it's my copied
it,
League.
EA wants it. That's what their whole.
my dick copy league. Remember?
Yeah, unfortunately, Dota's been around since I was in high school.
No, my copy league.
I was like a freshman in high school, and Dota existed.
Dota copied league.
Dota existed before League.
Dota haunt all of them.
I'm not talking about the new Dota. I'm talking about like the Warcraft 3 mod. The mod. I played that when I was a freshman or a sophomore in high school.
Dota copy.
Copy. We can only have one game per genre. One MOBA, one FPS, one puzzle game, one survival horror, one RPG. Imagine, just one.
If with that mentality, wow, we would be like
10 games.
Bored out of
the industry would be dead.
As long as Candy Crush is the puzzle one.
Yeah, right? As long as the puzzle one you can pay for.
Oof.
He was saying that you have to pay for more of the map too. Like, didn't you get like farther and you actually have to keep paying
for
more?
Yeah, you have to pay
for
another world.
Wow.
You have to pay a dollar.
A whole dollar.
I did it.
Microtransactions. They're feeding off of him.
So what's that?
So another thing we were trying to start plugging more is our RTX.
Roof
RTX. You guys don't know what RTX is.
I'm going to give Monty a hickey.
All right.
Rooster Teeth holds a convention in Austin once a year. They've been doing it for
Austin.
The past three.
They're going to have Google Fiber at the
We can go into the Google offices and be like, okay, can we
like, man, what's this Wi-Fi at? Like, 750 download? Like, all right.
Yeah, I can't take it. That's not good enough for me.
Yeah, that'd be insane. But yeah, so special thanks to Barbara over at Rooster Teeth. We had met her at the Dice Awards, and she set us up with a panel. So the first
person giving us a chance.
The first
PAX,
anybody finally
PAX shut
Barbara
us down.
From Rooster Teeth actually told me sees the potential.
Barbara making the plays.
Big play, Barbara going for the
PAX,
Penta.
PAX
down, from that half.
Penta
kill.
We
have a panel.
Our first panel ever.
Yep,
our fucking first panel ever.
Can't fuck
I
it up.
I still think we could have had panels at other conventions.
I know.
We got shut down for PAX Prime, which
that sucked.
We're gonna try. It was shut down at East.
You know what? No, but
it's
done. It's done. It's done.
PAX Prime is the next one we're gonna try.
It's
for
done though.
This,
it's like waitressing jobs.
Maybe
you need experience. Like majority of waitress jobs won't take you if you don't have experience.
Yeah, it's like
how the fuck can I get experience if you don't give me?
It's like no, you don't have
no
experience.
No, but it doesn't even matter experience wise. It doesn't really fucking matter because there's still YouTube content creators that get panels there that are in the same exact position as us, where they
get
fucking yeah.
So
like,
it's not really.
No,
they don't fucking do anything special there.
This is our time. This is
maybe
our
Barbara
time
can
to
put
shine,
in a good word
dude.
For us at Prime. Yeah. She, you know, put in a couple
like,
words.
These guys. No, here comes James with a box that says fragile.
Knowing us, though, fucking knowing us at Prime, we'll get a shitty ass time slot.
Yeah, it'll
be like 11 p.m. on Sunday.
One of those super late panel.
11 p.m.
Rooster
Sunday.
Teeth will be held in the main theater. We'll be over on the side.
Same time as them.
Same time as
if
them.
If you guys want to go to watch the creatures go to the toilet, they'll be sitting there.
That'd be a huge conflict of interest right there. That'd be
But
that
yeah,
would suck.
That's fucking epic.
That would
we got
suck.
It first.
Yeah, I'm excited. We already kind of have a plan for it. I had mentioned we're hoping to be done with being the stages of starting to release Trapville by then. So hopefully have something special.
Yeah.
In the Trapville. So yeah, that should be fun. So.
Thank you, Barbara.
There more than likely still be Q&A shit like that.
Yeah, there will
the
be
the usual
Q&A,
panel
yeah.
stuff.
You know what? You know what? We'll find. We gotta find something to make it different. We gotta either we can set
people
like,
want Q&A. You fuck. What
I
do
know,
you mean?
But we
let's not give them what they want.
No,
let's
no,
do something
no,
different
listen,
they don't
listen,
want.
Listen. Let me speak. Like, can I get the floor?
What do you have for an idea for a panel?
We can have Q&A.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then we all battle. And then whoever loses.
So we LARP?
Yeah,
so we kill each other.
Yeah. And then the weakest one, we set them on fire. No, that's entertaining.
I want to know what your legit idea was for this
panel.
No,
that was it. That was it.
Bullshit.
No, I swear to God, I swear that I just wanted to have somebody on fire in the end.
What the fuck?
Why don't you just light yourself on fire and protest?
I'm not gonna fight.
Like, what if we don't do it?
Referee. I'm like,
if we don't do it in protest, you can light yourself on fire. Like the monks that were protesting, they set themselves on fire.
Oh, I don't want to do that.
Well, I figure we'd probably show off a few videos or something like that, and then probably go into a Q&A or something like that.
Yeah.
I don't know. I'd imagine that's usually the format. I don't think we have anything other than that, though. I don't know.
We're going to do something. We're going to have like a piñata fucking fight-off or like...
Yeah? I bring my pinata.
Whoever brings the nicest PJs gets a gift from us.
I'll bring my pinata.
Whoever comes to that panel with a onesie, we give them a hug.
And I'll put.
Stop spoiling what we're gonna do.
How you gonna get a box for that pinata?
Yeah, I know. What am I gonna
do? You, we make it.
I'm trying to think what I could put inside the pinata.
Another box.
Another pinata.
A small pinata.
It's a small little pinata.
With a, like, it's like one thing of candy.
A lot of small pinatas inside that pinata.
Pinata
keychains. I like to say his name, pinata. Pinata. Such pinata. A nice word to pinata. So,
anyway.
I'll put like a liquid in there.
And ew.
Yeah. It'll stain all the fucking...
Oh, you were the one that broke the pinata.
Just put bleach in it.
Anyway. Oh, man. Like, go, everyone's shirts gets like... you know who all went to the creature panel.
It's all like bleach.
It gets in your hair.
Oh, so you're a creature fan, huh? Okay.
You got blonde speckles in your hair. There, man. But yeah, so if you're considering or you're in the area, you want to get tickets.
You should
considering,
go.
They should go.
You should really yeah. consider.
Considering, don't you know, be, saving, don't, if you're saving for a convention, you know, this consider
one.
This one.
Don't blow this for us.
But it's like if you're considering PAX over like RT, it kind of depends on what. If you're a fan Rooster Teeth, then definitely because, you know, it's Rooster Teeth.
If you're a fan of us, panel. It's a double whammy right there.
Yep, exactly. So
yeah, I'm sure there's going to be other panels there that they might find interesting or whatever. I don't know.
Yeah.
I didn't go last year, so I didn't see it.
Nanners you had fucking a panel last
yeah,
year.
There you go.
Yeah, we were there.
So what the fuck? There might be other stuff that might be interesting.
Yeah.
They can go to RTX.
Just go. What are you doing? You're going to stay home? No, just go. Just do it.
We'd be a lot less likely to have one for PAX, and then on top of that, we'd be a lot less likely to find at PAX than...
Yep.
RTX. I've heard that like booth selection and stuff has a lot to do with how good relations are with the PAX. Like,
what?
You know how like booths at PAX, you can see like some that were like right there when you walked in
yep.
and stuff.
Uh-huh.
Like a lot of that has to do with how good your relationship is with the PAX people.
So whose dick do I need to suck?
Would that know. Be like Gabe and the
was it Tycho or whatever?
I don't know.
Like would you not suck some major dick for a night spy? In
sure,
huh?
But I don't even have a booth. Why would I?
We'll get a booth.
I don't have an idea.
I wouldn't
for a
expect
booth.
Us to have a booth right at the bottom of the fucking escalator.
Stick.
Anyway,
no,
like
we were kind of talking about how we might have to move to booth formats instead of doing meetups in the future because it's getting pretty wild. And
yeah,
hard
more
to
moms
do.
Are gonna be calling me assholes.
Yeah,
you are an asshole. Right?
I'm gonna be bringing some brass knucks.
What you call it?
I'm gonna have Nova on each knuckle. It's gonna spell out Nova. So then,
you'll
be able to take that home with you with your mom's fucking stamp on the forehead right there.
I'm such a fine baby.
So anyway, another thing that happened the other. Past few days ago, Aram was released for Smite.
Oh!
It's
this is for
random.
Smite Club only, so
Smite
I'm
Club
leaving.
Only.
No, you were there. You were the cheerleader for that.
That's Smite Club only.
You were there.
So all random, all mid game type.
It's called Assault.
Which is called Assault, like I said. And, you know, if you didn't know, you get selected with a random god, and there's one lane, and...
I didn't like how the towers are just fucking trees. I don't know why. They just made it trees.
No, that's the. It fits in with the surroundings.
The map looks good.
It's Asgard.
So you put a tree there.
The towers are trees. It's terrible.
See, James agrees with me. Just trees.
So Slaz isn't gonna play Smite anymore because he's complaining about a bunch of trees.
A bunch of pointless shit.
So yeah, it's just great.
You were doing like
you can see Valhalla in the map.
You can see people fighting
yeah,
in the corners.
The warriors
they're
are
just
fighting.
Arguing at once.
I want a new mode called AM.
The Aether.
All Amir, all mid. I want that. I want that in the game.
You were doing some crazy combos with that Maddie dude in there, man.
Yeah, we
Maddie,
were. That
Maddie,
was fun.
We got to play. We
Marty
got to
Pocket
play the day before the Aaron was out.
We met him over at PAX.
Yeah, he was cool. I would do. I had Sobek. I'd never really played. I think I'd played Sobek once before.
Alligator Man.
I ran like I would always pull him back, and then Maddie would freeze him, and I'd go back, and he'd hit him with Rod. I'd hit him with Mike.
It was fucking
just,
funny.
Whoever got caught was not gonna have a good day.
You just bounce him back
yeah,
so many
it was
times.
Bad. And this is like one of the few times I actually got to play Raw. I was lasering so
oh, you were
hard.
Sniping.
I
was watching
like,
the stream.
I feel like Gris.
Yep.
Yeah, that Raw. I tried playing Raw. Like, I got Raw today in Aram. I didn't do too well. Okay, but because the snipe is pretty good. But
yeah, and so it doesn't give you a lot of room to, like, escape it. But I like it. You know, in this particular map, since Kucha doesn't want to mention any of that, you cannot teleport back. The only time you can buy items is in the beginning, or any time you die, you are teleported to your base. Because
the fountain or whatever is on a raised platform that once you fall off of it, you're...
And that's the whole point of an Aram. It's really fucking fun, and I like they did it. They're really, like, doing...
It's really... No, it really fits well for casual people, because if you really...
Me!
Like, James, who just wants to go and have fun. No one... you'll rarely get your god, so people on the other team rarely get their god.
Yeah!
So it does it. Sometimes
but,
there's some team
but when people
up,
get
but,
their god, you can tell. You can tell so bad. They're like... the score shows it's just
yeah.
so bad.
Yeah. Like when that person.
Sometimes you get really screwed over if there's like a full team of physical or a full
team
of magic.
Yeah, it's
you start
so bad.
Building against it.
Yeah, you have to really compete.
But again, a lot of people, and I think it feels a lot of people are gonna be like, "Oh, this is just a blank copy of League of Legends," you know.
Did they do that?
Them?
What League of Legends? Did they do that?
Yeah, but they have a the layout they have is just like straight. Mm-hmm. Where like obviously Smite they actually had like their own twist to it. It's just like I don't know, people just get butthurt if they have something similar. You just get butthurt.
Yeah, one game per genre. That would fix the
one
problem.
Game per genre.
And then the video game industry would be dead in a week. So,
but the problem's fixed.
The problem's fixed, yeah.
Why?
Why don't we just play the mod that started it all on Warcraft 3?
Just go play Dota.
Bring it back.
The Dota mod.
Let's do it.
The Dota, Defense of the Ancients.
Yo, I have like 50 fucking Dota keys on Steam.
I have like
two. Man. We can play Dota. Yeah. Just Dota for everyone.
Free
you
Dota.
You get a Dota. You get a Dota. Everybody gets Dota. They made sure everyone was playing that shit.
Yeah.
Have you guys run into any hackers yet in Smite?
In Smite hackers? No.
I saw one.
Yeah.
I recorded it.
Yeah, you were talking about
it. I recorded
hunters.
It, like so I got to show Borg. It was a speed. Yeah, it was a speed hacking Odin. He would, like, just, like, if one of your teammates was injured, he would just, like, run right up and start attacking them. And then if you attacked him and he got really injured, he would just speed hack back to base.
What do you mean speed hack?
He's like, running really fast.
He runs really fast. Like, if... You know Arena? Yeah. Like how the bases are? If he was at my base, he could get back to his base in about 1.5 seconds. Like he would be like, whoop, gone. And he would come right
you
back.
You know what's a funny thing though? Like the Smite community is so like solid with each other. Like they'll report.
You got that guy's name so I can ask him how to do that?
Yeah, I got the video. I'll just send you the video.
I'm gonna ask him how to do
but
that.
But yeah, his team, when the game was done, he's like, they're like, report our Odin.
What would Bort do?
That's no.
I was a hacker.
But listen to that, though. Like, their own team, like, report our Odin. Like, that's a good community. Like, they want to keep it legit.
So I just
but
gotta show Bort.
What would Bort do Bort if I was a hacker?
He would put his glasses and ban the shit out of you.
Whoa.
I'm gonna give him the video.
He'll put his glasses
on. I play on your guys' account.
I'm gonna show him.
Yeah, play on Sly's account.
Fuck! No!
Bored. Sly's speed hacking.
I could explain it to him, like when we're at an event or something. Like, listen, man, I'm not too good at the game.
I need this, Bored. I really need this.
Give me a fucking break. Alright?
You're lucky I'm not using the
get
no damage
ass
mod.
Get my ass beat as fucking Loki all the goddamn time.
Because you go so hard. You gotta play smart.
You gotta pick him off.
I was doing alright with Loki, but like...
You gotta pick people off.
Yeah, no, that thing is like, do. I don't know, he's like really...
You don't get into team fights, you just, you know, come
you
from behind,
yeah.
kill
find
one.
The one person that's building off.
Even somebody on the opposite team that was playing Loki and they tried to do that shit to me, like, they're really sneaky about it.
You
they come up
Loki.
To me, they fucking backstab me, I turn around, I fuck him up! Like, oh!
Like, what was
I don't know if he's just like really shit, like, health-wise
probably,
or what. Like,
he's low level.
Yeah.
They probably got a lot of crits
it's
on
kind of squishy.
Yeah, it's also about luck too, the whole crit thing. So you gotta think about that.
Whoa, going to League.
Good.
I'm going to Defense of the Ancients Warcraft 3 mod.
Yeah, I'm going with Sheamus.
That no one probably plays anymore.
Fuck it, then I'm just gonna go play Han. I don't know who plays that.
There's probably people on that game like, hey, didn't you guys play like Smite or
like that. This is what started it all.
What's the name of that game that you found? What was the side scroller?
Huh?
Awesome Knots?
Oh yeah, Awesome Knots. Dexter plays that all the time. He's like, dude,
it's pretty cool.
Good,
yeah,
good. So we can play. I'm like, but I'm playing Smite. He's like, you should get it. I'm like,
it's pretty right. fun.
I bet.
I played it with him.
I oh. played. There's a monkey.
But
in there.
I just League.
League.
Yeah. All about that League.
Give me that League.
Next topic.
What would Bort do if I wore a League of Legends shirt? When I seen him.
What if you went on their stream with a League of Legends shirt?
You went on their stream talking about League of Legends.
Sly fucking did at PAX. He went up there and the first thing he said was League.
League of Legends. Look at that booth over there. League of Legends.
Yeah. So what right. the
you guys want to play Dota?
First of all, at least I use it to compare and then I
actually okay,
make
okay.
props.
Use no. it to compare.
But,
oh, you're going to cut me down. I'm going to cut you off because I'm going to sit here and deal with this.
I'm gonna get myself a League of Legends shirt. I'm gonna get myself a League of Legends shirt. Send me a League of Legends shirt.
Hey guys, this is Kucha's mic.
What you? You
what the fuck is the point of that? It doesn't
gonna
make any
the
difference.
Same thing there. Hey, this is Kucha's mic.
Like they're
no
gonna.
No one would have known.
Oh, this that is came from the right side of
me. Oh my god, my ears. Whoa.
That mic's different.
Where did it come from? Hey, Kevin was actually streaming, doing some what was it?
Dark Souls.
No, shoutcasting some. Some League of Legends. Apparently this thing called Colorado League of Legends thing, and he was shoutcasting. The funny thing is, like, it was only coming through my left ear. And it was all the mic was peaking.
Was it really a Colorado like gaming thing? It was a Colorado Cutthroat?
I don't know what it was, but I was like, I hope he realized that he's only coming through my left ear and all other mic are peaking. Like, he had a co-host with him, and anytime something would happen, as a shoutcaster, there's specific roles. Like, there's someone that really would go into, oh, this is a team fight, whatever.
So there's someone who's technical, and there's someone who's just there for color commentary.
Yeah.
Like, one who has information, one who's just there for entertainment.
The one color commentary and play-by-play.
The problem is that his partner was so bad, because, like, one, he didn't even know what the champion's name was. He's like, oh, yeah, that tree. And then...
that tree.
And then
Kevin... No one seems to know what that fucking tree is, because they didn't know that it was in PAX either.
But then Kevin's like, me, Maokai. And he's like, oh, yeah, Maokai.
The tree.
And like,
what's his name? The tree.
Maokai.
Why can't you just say tree?
Yeah, that's...
Tree sounds so...
It's like a call-out. Like, tree.
Tree.
Maokai. Tree's coming. Tree's on. Maokai.
Fighting tree.
But when you're shoutcasting, you're supposed to have a certain amount of knowledge.
I can shoutcast.
Shoutcasted Hawken, and I said everything but Mechasaur.
By the way, there was the Call of Duty Championships.
Oh, yeah.
I watched some of those. The final match, I watched it.
That was kind of cool. Fariko won.
Yes, Fariko, or whatever their name is.
What are you being such a fucking cunt? Shut up.
This shoutcasting made me think, what would happen if the creatures were in charge of shoutcasting
a tournament?
Can you imagine, like, two of us at the desks, like, shoutcasting, and then we have, like different, like, people with the mics around.
I'm sorry, can you imagine?
Let's head down to the floor with Sly Fox Town.
As you can see here, we got the people in the soundproof booth, and they're setting up here. They're going hard. This guy's trying to get the team amped right now, and this is just insane what's going on right now. You can tell right now they have the drive to win this. We're looking at $400,000 at the top prize.
Dude, that was the top winner got $400K each for the top members.
No, it was
minus 40K each with taxes. Yeah. Government shoutcasting on their bank accounts.
So low.
Here we got 40% of your money.
What surprises me though, has League had, like, funny thing, at the same time, there was a competition, and this was...
So
this
you go
was
right to League?
This was happening, no. No, wait. God damn it. At the same time, on Twitch, there was happening, they were really pumping up this tournament and whatnot, and at the same time, League had a European tournament.
Yep.
League had 100-something thousand viewers, where this had, like, 40K at the time.
For the final match, they had, like, 130K at the Call of Duty thing, which was,
I would like. I think we could do that, but.
I think we could do what?
The whole shoutcast.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, no. That's what I was thinking. If we could figure out, at like a convention or something, and we get a slot as a shoutcasting team, like how insane would that be?
There'd be a lot of upset people.
Yeah.
They would know, like...
His name is Big Time or not Big Mac. What's wrong with
Big
you?
Mac, Big Mac!
This guy's got some sort of SMG.
What's wrong with me right now? I'm calling him Big Mac just for spite at it.
It's not Shrimp Scampi. It's Gumpy. What's wrong with you?
Come on, man. Well, okay, so everyone that thinks we should do a creature, like, shoutcast coverage of some kind of event, we need to light some fires here.
Shrimp Scampi goes with Big Mac, gets a double to go.
Using the P90 gun.
Oh, man.
What? There's no P90 in this. SMG, that's like a P90.
It's all the same. Here he comes with the laptop gun. Wait a minute. Perfect dark. Wrong game. Sorry. Got my textbooks mixed up for a minute.
Let's pull up this other wiki here.
Watch out.
Fuck, someone pull up the wiki.
There's a Maokai on that map. Oh, no.
The tree?
The tree.
There's a tree.
The tree came out.
Escape. The tree.
I'm sure if we could hook up with, like, high res or mid. Something like
don't
that.
Don't let us do something.
That would be, like, I don't know, though, because it's going
to
be.
High res is one of those people that would let us do kind of that shit.
Just talk to
Bort. Would the pros let us do that though? Would they?
Yeah, fuck them.
Yeah. Okay.
Wait. What do you mean? Like.
Like any games pros, if they're being all serious and stuff, and we're just.
But they don't hear.
They don't hear that. Why do they care?
We can actually just set up two matches between like two teams that we know. We can get Kurtz and Root, and we can just shout.
To be an event. I want suits.
We need suits for that. We need to look professional. But you still got to wear the red hat.
I'd sell the red hat and the suit.
Yeah. He'd have the beanie and the suit.
Anyway,
what's next?
Next topic, E3 is approaching.
Is that really an announcement?
He got something stupid on this list like every week where it's like The Hobbit is released.
Yeah,
just like a general announcement.
E3 is approaching.
Say that if you're watching this. Our setup for E3 is going to be different than most events.
That's what I brought it for you.
Hey, I booked the hotel last night. This morning.
It is. We even know who's all going to E3. Like,
we're still waiting on this guy right here.
I don't know if I'm going to go.
Oh, okay.
I don't know.
If you want to, we can set up the stuff after this. But anyway, I booked the hotel. It's in Hollywood. In the heart of Hollywood.
Oh, man.
I got... Wait. How many days did you book this for? Because remember, we said last year that you were going to be taking me to see the bums.
We are going to see any... We're right in the heart of Hollywood. The bums! God. The craziest of the bums
I'm
going to
see them bums.
Only the finest
and
Hollywood
the finest
bums.
Of the bums. And before a bum attacks James and bites his medulla.
I'll fucking run.
We'll get those brass nooks out.
I'll take this book. No, I'll fucking hit him with this book. This is a pretty big book.
Knowledge is power.
So, yeah, I got our hotel in Hollywood for two reasons. A few reasons.
One, you're high
everything was pretty much booked by the convention center.
Is the Starstrip thing there?
Yeah. Walk of Fame's right there. I booked it because it's right next to a metro, and we're going to be metro.
I'm
going
to go talk to them and be like, you know, okay, I got a YouTube channel.
And three, we are right in the heart of Hollywood, which is the craziest place, and there is, like, so much to do there.
Everybody's so star hungry.
And we're going to be, like, doing the random
guaranteed. We're going to get out of our fucking hotel room, and right around the corner is going to be a Subway. Because that's all there fucking is, all the goddamn time. It's always Subway.
No, there's a cool mall, like, that's right near there, because I stayed here like a block away from here when I was in Hollywood, you stayed in the same exact place,
so you know
in the same room.
I tried to look for it, but it wasn't. Couldn't find it. But anyway, so we got a hotel in Hollywood, and we're gonna be having a blast on Hollywood Boulevard and seeing all the stars. We'll see the stars. We'll walk into we'll see.
And the stars will
see
you.
Mickey Rourke. We'll just walk up and see Mickey Rourke and be like, Mickey Rourke, can you cry for me?
Can we see Gary Busey?
We could see Gary Busey.
Right. Now you'll see Nick Nolte.
Yeah, wait, you're Nick Nolte!
You'll see Nick Nolte.
Yeah, I just wanted to make sure people know that we're going
to
be...
How much of a bitch is that going to be to get to the goddamn convention?
I booked it. It's next to the metro, so there's a metro station outside.
We're going to be...
You see some Subway bums.
This is going to be an adventure and a half to get to the fucking convention center.
I took the metro when I was there.
It'll be fun. I'm not gonna be there, so there won't be a slide versus E3, so you can just completely go apeshit all over the place.
Yep.
Well, we got media this time for E3.
Ooh. Yeah, we're gonna be cutting every single line.
I feel really bad. Awesome. I will try my best to apologize to the people I'm cutting in front of, because I hated being that, like, I hated those people when I was in that position, but like,
he's like dragging that
thing. I'm gonna like be very cordial about it.
Yeah,
I'm gonna be laughing at him.
When we did it at the Saints row line, he was like, "I'm sorry, I hate to be this."
I apologize at the Saints row line. I did.
There was like a 2-hour line.
Because I know how it is when they fucking come up and cut in front of you. Like,
that's
gonna
be us. And they have all. We need to get notepads, because they would always have their notepads. They'd be sitting there.
I'd be like doodling a
picture. I have no idea what they're.
I think my memory is at least all right enough that I could remember some
of
the
Kucha
shit.
They need to play
Kucha
the part.
Needs to actually play,
I didn't need
player.
To like whip out my shit during the Watch Dogs presentation, because it was, for the most part, half of it was already shown.
Yeah.
And for the other half, I could remember
it. He got it.
Fuck.
It'll be fun though. We'll be.
But they're mostly like journalists and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Like, we're not journalists.
Why aren't you a journalist?
I could be a journalist.
This is our journalism right here. We're talking into our journalism outlet, Creech Talk.
True.
That's our journalism outlet.
Put that on your pipe and smoke it.
Yeah. We didn't even sign up with that. Like, I fucking did photos.
I did.
Did you really?
Yep.
And it worked.
Yeah.
So. Okay, so we got two different ways. I just did photography. I didn't know. No,
even though
fucking...
I'm the photographer,
yeah,
me and Dan are the standard.
That's what happens when no one helps me to fucking sign up. So I just do it myself, and I bootleg half of the shit. So whatever. I still got in.
E3. We'll see who else going.
What is it? That's
Sly ducked out, but it's going to be me, Dan, Z, James, and then possibly Seamus.
Spoon not going?
No. He doesn't go. He doesn't go to anything but PAX Prime.
PAX Prime, that's it.
I have no idea.
So he's not going to RTX then?
Nope.
Right.
He wouldn't want to show his face.
Yeah.
Well, I'm not saying he should be on, like, the panel, but...
He'll be around it, though. I mean,
he would, yeah. What are you?
I don't know. RTX isn't as like. I guess it would be more. I think we would probably get stopped a good bit at RTX because it would be like.
We did last time.
Yeah. It's not.
And our fan meetup was pretty big.
We get stopped like everywhere except for E3. That was really the only place E3 we didn't get stopped.
Not really like toward, but that. Then again, that's not really. Yeah. That's more industry stuff.
So June is E3. We have Comic Con as well.
June.
That's in July as well. Shit, that's like right after RTX.
Yeah, this is like the gauntlet. Yeah.
So far, I think I'm the only one confirmed for fucking Comic-Con.
Yeah, we don't really know how to get in there, so.
I'm gonna be like, what the fuck?
Have fun?
James had like one other pass, so if someone
Maybe. See, I might have to call them up and see about doing that if somebody else wants to fill in. So, I don't know.
We figured out PAX Australia is off the table completely, because that would be...
It's at the same time as...
That would be the same time as...
Something. As PAX.
No,
Comic-Con. Comic-Con. Yeah. They overlap each other.
Hmm.
Yeah. So,
that sucks.
We could split, and a few of us go to Comic-Con, a few of us go to PAX Australia. Who wants to go to Australia?
I would definitely go to Australia.
You got your passport?
Nope.
I don't know. Oops. I can't even get my passport.
I know where to get mine in less than 2 days.
Really?
I got mine in like 2 or 3 days before we went to Paris.
I know where to not get mine ever until I get not getting one ever, so I'm staying here in the country.
I want to know.
Yeah, we're lucky because we have a passport like agency here in Denver. Yeah, so it's like super. They'll print it.
After me and Dan got ours, like we had to go through the whole process. We had to sit there and wait for ours.
He went speedy.
Yeah, and I just went in there. I was like, okay, I need this, and they're like, okay, you can come tomorrow and get it.
It's fast way to see slips a few hundred some bitches.
Yeah,
no, it's a little bit more expensive than normal, but it's like whatever the expedited. Yeah, it's worth it if you need it.
I use that shit for just going on normal flights. It's so much easier than whipping out my fucking ID and stuff.
One other thing. That we won't talk about too much, but Arkham Origins was announced. Because Dan will be here probably next time. But I was just gonna say,
yeah, you can probably talk about it.
Well, it's gonna be too late. It's gonna be too late.
It's not gonna be on the Game Boy Advance.
It's already gonna be
on Game Boy Advance title.
It was in Sega Genesis.
Yeah, maybe. What the hell is that? Side scroller.
Sega's coming back.
All I know about it is that it's.
I said legitimately. This isn't Rocksteady making this one.
That's what I was
This is a
say.
Completely different dev team.
Oh,
and
no.
It's the dev team that made Prototype. Prototype and the Incredible Hulk Ultimate Destruction. It's that team that's doing this.
So basically, we can expect another Prototype. Hulk.
Prototype Hulk animations. Yeah. Hulk animations with Batman.
Fucking Batman's gonna be jumping from buildings. Walking, like, running in the air.
Oh my god, are you serious?
For like the fourth game in a row, fifth game in a row from them, but yeah, it's done. Jesus.
They just retexture everything.
Like a fucking, like a game from like 2002 or 2003. Yes, that's perfectly fine in this day and age that they're still using that same fucking shit, you know?
If you're a Batman fan.
10 years later, no big deal.
If you're a Batman fan.
Oh, it's got a, what's his name in it? Deathstroke is in there.
I see that, fuck you.
Oh, right, he's in there.
Fuck you.
He felt the pain after I whooped Alex's ass with the stroke, and felt that he finally found someone to beat me with him, though.
But yeah, so we'll probably get into more of that later when more stuff's released. There is also a new shirt that I am going to upload right after Creech Talk.
What is it?
It's the Red Velvet shirt.
Ooh!
R.I.P. Red Velvet.
Aww. Is it like all moldy?
Yes, it is.
Really?
It's nasty, yeah.
Good.
That was awesome.
So that's going to be up. And then pretty much the last thing on the list, Black Ops 2 DLC. Which
I won't be getting.
We're gonna play the zombies mode, and it's the mod.
I don't think there's anything else in there that I give a shit about.
Oh, I was
watching their breakdown of the multiplayer.
You can play four people, and they're gonna play. Do you want to play zombies with me, man?
I don't know. Do you have the dimensions?
Dimensions for him.
I need the dimensions.
I can't.
DLC dimensions.
We've been fucking doing zombies since day one. Never have I received a message. Hey, can I get in on that? No. Because I would say, do you have the fucking dimensions? Because then if you do, then you'd be able to get the fuck in.
All right. The dimensions are
5x3. 5x3.
5x3, you're fucking wrong. Because it's 4x3.
Shit!
Damn it.
Whoa!
Now I have it though! He gave it to me.
Wrong.
Yeah.
So yeah, there's like Ray Liotta and a couple other mobs.
Yeah, let's
I
want to
be Ray Liotta.
They're all on Alcatraz. And it looks so complicated and complex that me and James are going to scratch the surface and not get anywhere close to doing it.
Don't be including me when you fucking, when you say shit like this, because this is you that fuck up all the time. Like, you're the one that
does
this.
If it was just me, then we would have at least gotten somewhere. We never get anywhere, so it's got to be both of us.
Hey, right now you have lost all rights.
It's because, you know, I'm terrible. You lost all rights. I'm terrible at this, so James can perform at high, you know, and normal.
You, you lost all rights of talking right now because the teacher.
Okay.
Class is in session.
Class is in session, guys. Welcome back.
And we need a jingle for this stuff.
What is the
Can we get a jingle?
Do you remember the title?
We don't have a jingle for this
yet. We need a jingle for this stuff.
What is it?
What the fuck is that? It's building a foundation for the future.
What, James?
So,
this is where we left off.
I already have it right here. All right. I have where we left off.
These are my notes that I was taking.
Everybody, if you guys missed our previous
podcast. Your notes. Okay.
We brought a new session called Building a Foundation for the Future.
Yes.
And future is important.
The teacher and we're the students.
Basically, I took this upon myself because I realized that there's many, many stupid people in the world.
Uneducated masses.
I'm one of them.
I didn't even know the dimensions of the DLC.
The thing is that they don't have to be that stupid.
Wait, you can fix my stupidity?
You fucking botched saying that, so I think by the end of this, we can fix your stupid.
I feel like I can get this. Thank you. I will.
He's like, can you fix my stupid?
Stupidity. Question though, my partner Seamus help me out?
Your life partner, or
yes,
just
you are,
partner?
You're allowed to actually seek advice from other people.
People who are
learning faster than you.
Okay.
Phone a friend.
Use all of your lifelines.
Ready. I'm ready to take notes.
All right, so last time, let me go ahead and review what I did last time. I did the first five points. I will review for Seamus.
Reviewing.
Number one was that I was to make sure that students write several times daily.
I started doing that.
Yes.
I never forget about things and shit.
Number two was to give students regular opportunities to write to a prompt as well as to other self-select topics.
The other day, I wrote about Chef.
So you wrote about your own self-selected topic.
Very selfishly.
That's good. That's good.
Chef liked it. I showed it to you.
Number three was I was to provide numerous opportunities for timed writing because you have to be quick.
I was scared of that one.
You're scared about it? It'll come eventually. Naturally. It will be good. It will flow. You'll be able to whip something up, an essay for Chef. 2 minutes tops.
That's speed writing.
She got really upset at me. I took too long. She couldn't eat.
I'm sure no one wants to sit around for 45 minutes.
She shit on the floor while you're probably doing it.
No one wants to sit around that long waiting for an essay.
Mm-mm. Not even Chef.
Number four was to have my students revise papers within the time limits.
I did.
Again with time.
I did that to myself, and I just kept complimenting myself. I'm like, you're doing good.
See, that's what you can't do. You have to scold yourself. You can't compliment yourself.
But if I do a lot of good work.
If you compliment yourself, then you're settled. You feel like you've done a good job.
You're blowing your head up like a balloon.
Don't settle.
Don't settle for less.
That was my mistake. I knew it. I felt like there was something wrong with that. And
that could have been what was holding you back time-wise.
And you learned.
I felt like I did it all.
And number five was that I was to teach a variety of planning techniques, such as, here they are.
And here comes the big one.
Note-taking.
The big one. I remember it was the last one.
Listing.
I started listing stuff.
Here we go. Have you done the big one?
No.
Webbing. That's the one that you need to work on.
Webbing. I didn't have enough things to web. And when
there is always enough things to web.
You find things to web.
The excuses that I'm hearing right now, it's unbelievable.
All
right,
so you think the next few steps will help me?
Maybe.
They might.
We will explore these next five steps.
Give me a hug real quick. I need some support.
Number six is to teach revision.
Revise.
And proof reading. And give students opportunities to apply these skills in timed sessions.
Get with the time. You know what? Time.
Multiple time sessions. Not just one. Multiple.
I was reading dialogue from Kingdom Hearts and I was reading it wrong. Maybe this is the time that I will actually master that.
You're doing a lot of things wrong in Kingdom Hearts.
Exactly.
I can help you after
And this. I feel like this is partly my fault that I should have been there to help you with that and proofread for you and help you revise to teach you how to do that.
And then
you would have been able to do that on your own.
Yeah, no, it's true.
So sure. we're gonna have to pair up later, and I'll have to teach you.
No, it's
tutor session.
Tutor me.
Yes.
How much do I have to pay extra for this?
A lot.
We won't discuss that privately.
Okay.
Privately later. Number seven.
All right.
I am to teach students to edit in a short daily interactive session.
There's days that I want to edit, and it takes me weeks.
By interactive.
What do you mean, not interactive?
Interactive. What I'm saying with interactive is it doesn't have to be you by yourself. You don't have to be alone on this journey.
Partner.
You don't have to be alone on this journey.
Give me a second. Seamus is already helping me too much. I need to take the weight off his shoulders. Kutra. Can you help me edit my videos?
Spread it around.
What?
Spread it around.
The thing is, it's interactive. We have to team up to edit and revise these things on this paper. Like right here.
What is that?
There's only one B in this webbing.
Exactly. See that?
There needs to be two in there.
I didn't write that.
It's who wrote a good that? Thing that you spotted this.
That is
revision.
Holy
revision
shit.
Right there.
It all makes sense. Who wrote webbing?
Exactly.
Who wrote that?
I did.
So you caught your own mistake.
Doing what he told earlier, I did it in a time limit.
That is the first few lessons he's applying them.
He learned a lot of stuff.
The first 5 points, and he's applying them here today.
He ran with them. Picked him up and ran.
I couldn't do it.
And remember, he was the fucking idiot last time.
He studied.
I'm fucking dumb as
shit. He's been doing his research.
I didn't. I tried webbing. I was... No.
Point being, interactive.
It's a pressure, though. It's a pressure.
You're not in it
alone. We will sit down after this, all three of us together, the students, and edit this entire piece of paper.
Exactly. Yeah. Right. As long as you're interactive about it, share your
experiences.
Don't do
it in quiet. Don't do it, you know, to yourself.
What did you just say? Don't do it in quiet?
See, now he already... Wait, is there another step to fix? Whatever.
Can you revise verbal things? Is that possible or no?
It's kind of hard to do that. I suggest you make up a web right now.
Take a web in right now. Do it.
Okay.
What is this webbing with? Write your mistake. What was your mistake, did you say?
My mistake was quiet.
Quiet. All right. What led that mistake?
Yes. Insolence?
Yes.
Okay, what else? There's more to that. I know.
Competence.
Can I help him with the next one?
Competence.
Interactivity.
Can I help you with the next one? I can tell you, and I bet
these are the eyes. Yes. The eyes of our foundation.
Yes.
I know it's not an eye, but I know another reason why you couldn't say that. Your red hat.
Vice of the red hat.
Teacher, do you believe that your red hat is a vice?
I think it's a... You're
gripping
using
it.
Has
your
head? Red hat been holding you back your entire life?
Have you settled on that red hat?
I got a new one.
Okay,
because I felt
true.
It's
not.
I
that
felt that
maybe
it was...
Maybe it's the fact that it's new. I'm not used to it.
And maybe you're not in your groove
yet.
Yeah,
maybe it needs its wear and tear for a little bit.
Throw it in the lake.
Irresponsibility. Red hat, irresponsibility. I can see the connection. Webbing.
Yes.
Holy
this
shit.
Is what happens when you web.
My
figure
I've
stuff out.
Changed in the past 2 minutes because I have webbed out this problem that I mm-hmm. introduced, and I'm growing.
James. I can see
into growing.
What is
the
it?
Next step?
No,
number 8.
No, you're gonna throw me out. No, this is a. I can't.
This is a lot of steps.
I'm not ready for this, James. It's coming. I'm not ready for this.
Wait, it's what? Coming.
He's abandoned the learning process.
I'm not ready for this one, James.
Are you ready for focused mini lessons on writing? For different purposes and audiences. Different audiences.
This is
not just one
variety.
Audience.
Variety.
Yes.
Variety.
As well, there's
know.
More. There's
know.
More.
I don't know, James.
There's more. As well as writing
mm-hmm.
in different, this might be tough on you, in okay, different go. Genres.
I can't. I just can't. Seamus.
I knew that would hit him
Seamus,
hard. I
on,
knew
man.
That would hit him hard.
Seamus.
Different genres.
Come on.
What format do you write right now to Chef? Only one genre. To one audience. You need to open it up.
You gotta expand.
You need to be able to write to Natalie.
She doesn't judge me.
What about me?
You need to write to Seamus.
Chef's a dog. Natalie's a girl.
You need to be able to write to Alex.
Yeah, you got...
Alex, Natalie, Seamus.
Like, I'm sarcastic.
They're all different.
Alex is Russian. Can you write an essay in Russian for Alex?
I probably could.
Not only in Russian dialect, but you need Russian culture inside this essay.
Babushka.
If I do that, would I be able to still write to Chef?
Yes.
Okay, then
you better be able to.
You
that's
take,
the point.
You take the foundation that you've learned with writing to Chef, and you apply it to writing with different audiences and different genres. This you is, need to have different genres in there. Otherwise, you're going to be very basic, very plain.
I can't do that.
And you will not be able to get the foundation
you don't
want to
settle.
Such as webbing.
I can't web.
You won't be able
you
to web.
You need to be able to web in different styles. You yes. can't only do a circle web because
you
that's,
see how the way his
normal.
Web. I mean, this is all the same shit. This is all the same web.
Yeah.
It's
this
one
is
in the
fucking
middle.
Atrocious because I cannot believe what you have been doing here. You
what
made
the fuck
one
is this?
This is a smiley face. I fucking put smiley faces on your paper. You do not do that yourself. Mark that off.
Can I help
Mark
you?
That off. Mark that off. And then, when I feel like this is a good enough paper, I'll put a smiley face on it. Is that an idea?
That was an
like,
idea.
Yeah.
It was a bad
time,
idea.
Next time you take your fucking idea and you web it. You web it.
I did.
Or maybe list it.
You could have.
I don't suggest listing
you
too much.
I didn't list it because I did feel that webbing conveys a better idea.
But again, you've settled into the same style.
He's not even using his bullet points.
Well, there's a few. I don't know if those are bullet points or there's a period.
I consolidated them right there.
Oh. Okay. Okay.
So, you know, they were on the paper.
Either way, you need a different style of webbing because this is disgusting. This is disgusting, and I don't want to see this again. So, get a new piece of paper. You bled through the back on this one.
Why would you use a marker for this?
He's using a marker to do example webbing.
That was problem number one.
Unbelievable.
Where's your paper?
I don't see it. No, get a fucking new one! He should have told you to get a new one.
Does it have important information on it?
Yes, it does.
Use the bottom of it.
Okay.
The bottom.
Alright, number 9.
Wait, you think I can recoup from 8?
Do you feel, like, confident that you are good enough to write in different genres? Two different audiences?
Yeah.
You'll have to practice. You'll have to practice. Yeah. That's an awesome
I'm not confident, but I believe in myself. And that's
isn't that confidence?
Don't even worry about the time is right it, now. Don't no worry time? About timing.
Isn't that just kind of like a synonym?
Just get it down.
Like
who knows about synonyms? I don't know about that either.
Cinnamon is
cinnamon.
Very, very out there when it comes to language and guiding readers and writers.
Cinnamon.
What? We don't use cinnamon very often.
Okay. Only for challenges.
It's fine.
Your homework is to do a webbing on cinnamon.
Okay.
Can I start that webbing?
No.
No!
It's his homework.
It's my homework.
Just his? We don't get homework to stimulate our brains? Just he gets homework?
He needs the homework.
You came into this, I thought, ready to go. And then what you showed me was that you need help all around the edges.
You think number 9 can help him?
Number 9 might be able to help you.
All right, Kusha, this is all you. Listen.
Okay.
Because I got 8.
Students will learn how to write about their reading.
Wait.
Mm-hmm. So you read and then you write
about
it.
You proofread. That's considered reading. You proofread and then you write about your proofreading. You write another essay on the essay that you wrote just proofreading.
Essayception.
I proofread my webbing. Let's see if I can, you know. Right,
can you write about it?
I messed up.
Already?
You put a number 3.
Why is there a 3 there?
Can I mark that off too?
Yeah, you can.
I'm the official teacher's pet.
Wait.
Man, you are failing.
How are you
going to
fix that?
How are you going to fix that?
What is going on here? Okay, mate.
He got you.
He fixed
it. He got us.
He fixed it.
He turned the 3 into a B and wrote webbing.
Interesting. Interesting
Jesus.
Concept.
He fixed it.
He proofread that.
Okay.
Can I get a green check mark next to that?
Green?
Yeah. Can I write that, teacher?
I'll do that.
You're not qualified for that.
I'm the teacher's pet. Shut up.
You're not qualified for that.
Okay.
Nobody likes teacher's pets.
I don't like
myself. Me and Jordan are going to be against you real soon.
I'll befriend you.
Is that a piece of poop?
Yeah.
Ew.
Oh, man.
It's steaming.
Okay, how many more are there?
It's steaming.
There's one more.
Okay.
This is the last one.
It's a long one. It's a long one.
Oh, man. Damn. Can Shaman take on this one? Take the role on this one, man.
I've been helping out everyone. Why are you trying to throw me under the bus?
He hasn't had any problems thus far.
That's not good interaction.
You've had issues. He's had issues.
I'm sorry.
Listen.
He doesn't know how to interact for it. I mean, he's throwing me under the bus
different
for no
audiences.
Reason.
He knows one audience. He knows Chef, and that's it.
I need to learn. Yeah.
Different audiences.
What do I need to do to get you as my audience?
Not throw me under the bus?
I will not throw you under the bus.
All right.
Students.
You've got me.
Students.
Me.
Us.
We'll learn to read the prompt and the questions to understand the writing task at hand. And select the organization pattern, in parentheses, graphic organizer, that will best suit an effective written response. Basically, let me break this down.
Please.
This is a lot to take in.
Dial it, Mom. Break it down, teacher.
It's like overflow.
You need to break down what you're looking at. Break down bit by bit what you're looking at.
Okay.
So that way it's easily able to be digested by not only you, but other audience members.
Variety of audience.
And then you apply a graphic organizer
It's like a chart.
What would that go to? Where's my other paper?
Seamus,
like a chart?
Have you seen Seamus tweet a lot about charts?
Yeah, I have a lot of graphs and stuff. I do.
Can I learn from that?
It's graphic organizing. We need to refer Seamus. Back to the three: notes, lists, and webbing.
Webbing.
Good web. Yeah.
How do you organize?
I consider charts like, you know, graphs and stuff like that. That's actually credit because that's not even listed.
Damn.
That's not even listed. He came up with that on his own. That was not even in the fucking Seamus. Book.
I'm out there. I'm looking to pass this class hard.
I wish I was like Seamus.
So, quick question. Extra credit. Right now, if you can do, as a teacher, an overview of your students, one by one, where do we stand right now?
I thought that was supposed to be judged in private on a report card.
Yeah, we're not supposed to know what each other's
parents' eyes only. And you want to
I
show.
No. Hey. I have my hands up.
What? What do you want?
It's one hand.
It was a suggestion. You think you could right now?
Do you want a personal evaluation of yourself right now?
Would you be able to also have
my? I'm not requesting it.
I'm
gonna get my report card.
Okay. Yeah, I want the report card.
You want a personal evaluation in front of the class? That's you.
Hey, my students are not.
Your students?
What?
Whoa!
Oh my god!
Whose fucking class is this again?
Sorry, teacher. It's yours.
You want a personal evaluation? You fucking failed.
I failed.
You failed.
What do I need to do?
You can't write to different audiences. You can't write on different genres.
I can't.
Your webbing is absolutely atrocious.
I haven't even wrote it.
You don't know what the fuck any of this means.
I don't.
Why are you here?
I am passionate about this class.
My asshole.
Until next time, building a better foundation for the future
proofread,
with James.
Proofread, and then write about your proofreading.
You got extra homework.
<That's fun>. Anyway, thanks for joining Stock, everyone. Until next time.
Close the book
to end it out. I'll cut it out.
There's right only after. 4 points left.
Close the book loudly so I can cut it at that. There it is.